Hello, I'm Ross
Hi.
of Arming D.
Hey, Ross.
And this is, well, I almost say Dungeon Dragon, Warhammer, Total
40K.
War, 40k.
It's not Total War, man.
It's
not
war.
Total War, I lied to you. It's just Warhammer 40k, only
lying
war.
In the first.
I'm already lying. Okay, it's not me in charge of this campaign, so I don't have to continue.
Yes, that would be me, wouldn't it? So my name's Scott. We've got the player characters that we usually have: Ross, Johan, Philip, and Alex,
Hi.
Who we haven't actually played with for a while, have we?
It's been
It has been a while.
Yeah.
Too long.
How have you been, Alex? Let's have some chit chat right before the session starts. How's the past half year been treating you?
Not too bad, Philip.
Did you do any major business transactions and you know? Any cool stuff? Any mansions? Any cars?
No, I wish nothing that interesting, I'm afraid.
Any Hearthstone tournament?
Nothing really long that cuts into the YouTube video.
Legend or I don't know anything.
extremely sensitive commercial information.
Yeah, anyone live on YouTube.
I'm not at liberty to discuss these things. Stop putting me under pressure.
next time you want to play D&D, then better bring your lawyer, okay? My client would like to roll a d20 to make an investigation check.
Objection.
No, it's d100s now.
D100s, not d20s.
Yeah, it's d100.
It was just an example, man.
Well, if you're going to make jokes, Philip, at least make them correct.
Yeah. At least put some effort.
You can't treat me like this. I'm gonna get my lawyer involved in this.
Anywho, so as Ross said, we're playing Only War, and we'll be playing the intro module from the core rulebook against the savages. I suppose I better
make
bring
sure.
it over to the start page.
Ooh, the start page.
Let me
I
see
love
if
start pages.
Why do you need a start page? On an unreleased battle. Why have you got Iron Brew?
Yeah.
It's available in the market.
Yeah.
Who recognizes music?
Johan, stop stealing Scott's show.
Yeah. Look at this wonderful thing he's created.
Took me all in about 30 seconds. Anywho.
I like the music.
Yeah, it's
Donald
Trump
it?
Music.
Against the Savages.
No,
yes, so, I suppose I better start by introducing the regiment that you guys created. The 501, first regiment created from, what's the planet called? Karine, is that how I think we pronounce it? Karine.
Yeah,
well,
thank you,
I'll
you
go
with what
you said.
That was the random generation, so.
Ah.
Yes,
should like translated Phoenix to Greek or something.
The first regiment of Karine, or as they go by nickname, the Phoenix Regiment. Suppose you guys want to go introduce yourself, your characters?
Yeah,
yeah,
who wants to go first? Okay, so
I suppose we better go with Sergeant, that makes sense.
Yeah, I guess the one who will lead this silly sottish troop of misfits and idiots who can't even read or write into dangerous, deadly reconnaissance missions is gonna be the Sergeant. His name is Kev Saron, but most people just call him Cobra because he's a badass. And this badassness is very like unconventionally derived from his like incredible laziness. So he's always trying to like get the most success with the least possible effort, which sometimes, you know, if there's a lot at stake, you can get some pretty nice stuff done. So yeah, he has quite the track record and was promoted and managed to stay alive to the age of 26, which is like he has been in service of this regiment for 8 years now. So yeah, that's pretty neat. Wait, no, it's not 8 years, it's only 4 years, I think. Yeah. Should I say anything about his like what he looks like, or do we do that later?
I suppose introduce what kind of character he is, what kind of role you play in him.
Well, I guess as a sergeant, I have to keep the men together, right? It's not necessarily my ability in combat that makes me stand out. It's how I motivate the people and finish the mission, you know, give the orders and make sure everybody does what they're supposed to do. And yeah, my bodily frame that is most similar to that of a gorilla supports that as well. I'm very even though I am pretty lazy, I also, you know, I still give the men reason to follow me, not only in speech but also in physique. Yeah, I guess.
Cool. So
I love it.
There he is.
Most of the time he's not groomed at all, only if like officials come or before a mission.
So yeah, I mean, do you just want to go with the image on screen or?
Yeah, I mean, it was, I in my description it says like he has dark blonde hair, but it's like, just imagine him in dark
close
blonde.
Enough.
Close enough. I mean, most likely his face is going to look different every mission anyways, because he's going to get shot and hit and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah, and he most definitely does not have a bolt pistol.
Yeah, of course not. He has a last pistol and a chainsaw.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. Who wants to introduce next then?
Ross!
Yes. So I'm Sep, or Costa. Priest Emperor, Master of Humanity, and he is a pretty green soldier who spent more time with the regiment as not a combat role, more like administrative. Yeah, that's right, I start with this fantastic backstory. As an only war, as an only war Imperial Guardsman.
So Seth was going to the office one day when he realized it was bombs away.
Well, enjoy. Obviously, the battalion's been recruiting a lot, and he got caught up in the recruitment drive, and he kind of knows me about it. He's getting a bit bored of being in the office, and because he was, you know, he's working back in the backlogs, he knew about the armory, and he knew what guns had been lost and didn't have any owners anymore, so he got his hands on a metal gun, because it's like, yeah, that's pretty fucking cool. I've always wanted to weld shit together, because apparently, what is it? I don't know. He described it as a welder.
Just so I can interject slightly, that's actually quite a good point about the Imperial Guard, the logistics side of it, because it's obviously on a galactic scale. Stuff
you
goes missing.
You can't always have what you want, but sometimes you get what you need.
Yep,
yeah,
so
stuff goes missing. So.
So very much in very well flavor, you could say, fantastically researched. And very suits the campaign. Yeah, so he got his metal gun, and he figured he didn't want to really fight that much, so he kind of knew a bit about all the people, because, you know, he's got the database in front of him, you know, it says a bit. He looked up all the different sergeants, and he sounded lazy sergeant. He's like, who can I get away with doing not a lot under? He's like, notably Cobra, pretty lazy, so he got himself in that squad, and now he's
somebody
there.
Somebody thought wrong.
Praise the Emperor, because the Emperor led him to the metal gun, and the Emperor leads us all to salvation.
Okay, so what type of character is Sep?
Yeah, he's a weapon specialist for the metal gun that he's got.
So he's a gung-ho pen pusher.
Exactly.
what is his demeanor? Did you mention it already?
Priest Emperor, no. I haven't mentioned
it. Oh, yeah,
demeanor.
Of course.
He is pious. He is pious. And that is why he knew when he got that email saying missing metal gun, anyone know who it belongs to? That's when he realised the Emperor was giving him a sign. And he took that sign and followed it to Sergeant Corporal's side.
Cool. So, Johan or Alex, who's next?
Yeah, I'm gonna go. yeah, my backstory is not a pencil pusher. Yeah, but my character is called Bell Dragonfly Ehringer, and she's can't seem to bring up the character sheet.
Nice.
Ah, okay, now it works. Yeah, she's a fairly, I don't know, she's a little like the Overwatch character.
Which one, Johan?
The pink-haired one, the Russian girl.
Oh, the one with the biceps.
Yeah.
The melon crusher. Zenyatta's? Oh, no, that's the Indian guy.
Zaira.
Zarya.
Yeah,
and yeah, she's been in gangs and everything when she was young, and then the Empire picked her up when there was a big recruitment drive, just like with everybody, it seems.
Yeah, so let me just cut in there real quick. So the regiment at the moment was on the 7th draft. Obviously, regiments need to repopulate their pools of soldiers. So even though it's quite a young regiment, we're in the 7th full draft. I'm under the impression that a few of you have maybe been in for a couple of drafts. Some of you may have come in on the 7th draft.
How often do they draft?
Well, it's every couple of years or so.
Well, I've been on 4 years, so...
Yeah, every 4 or 5 years, something like that.
Okay.
Sorry, carry on,
Johan. Yeah, and she's been in the academy for some time. It turned out that she's, quite good at fighting, and...
Which is why they decided not to teach her how to read and write, like any of us others of our characters.
I mean, basically, she was good enough to get the training to become a, what's it called, a stormtrooper. So that added like another 2 semesters of studies, another training part.
Yeah, basically the stormtroopers are your kind of career soldiers. They're the guys that, instead of being taught how to do biology or science or maths or anything, they go in and they learn. Soldier skills, how to survive, and yeah,
are those common subjects in the Death World school system, biology and maths?
No, that was me. Bit of hyperbole there.
Oh, I see, okay. But we get a Praise Emperor class, right? Do we even have schools? Do we have schools? I don't know how it works.
Yeah, there's all sorts of schools. So you'll have, they'd be all sorts, so you've got your. Most of them would be schools run by the Ecclesiarchy, so the church. But,
okay.
For example, the stormtroopers are from the Scholar Progenium, which is like its own kind of school.
Yeah.
Through a military school.
So I may have been to like the Ministratum, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And is there like churches? Do people go to church?
Yeah. So the main church for the 40k Human Universe is the Ecclesiarchy. And that's the church of the God.
So you go there and sing hymns to like the emperor.
Yeah.
Okay.
And different worlds within reason are allowed to worship the emperor. So some worship him as the sun. So if you're from a world where you don't really have much chance of getting off the world or much connections to the outside world, you may worship the sun as the emperor.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Praise the sun.
You may. But, I like to imagine like a bunch of Space Marine and Imperial Army just crushing down on a planet, burning everything down. So,
no, that's exactly it.
You now may praise the sun as our emperor.
No, that's it. There's the Inquisitors, the Inquisition, which is another institution.
That happened to our other planet. The Inquisition destroyed them, right? Isn't that what you said?
I cannot remember. We didn't actually iron that out.
It's in your backstory for the regiment.
Yeah. Anywho, so what kind of character?
Wiped clean by the Armageddon of the Inquisition.
Yeah, sorry, that was it. Yeah. So what was your character type that you're playing, Johan? You said stormtrooper, didn't you?
Yeah. I mean, she has very well armored. She is buff and trained and everything, and I think she's been with the regiment for a few missions, not too much. And since stormtroopers are like the well trained soldiers, she's a little bit of an outsider. But battle is like her time. If there's like battle around, she blossoms into a pretty vocal person.
Into a beautiful flower.
Yeah,
she's
not much of a
people person, then.
Yeah.
Okay.
More like a beating person.
I mean, none of us are much like a people person.
Yeah. That's understandable. All right. Anything else you'd like to say?
No.
Righto. Alex, that leaves us with you.
Yes. My character is called Yuri. He's a weapons specialist. Focusing on marksmanship.
I love Yuri already.
Who doesn't? He's a lot older than the other guys. He's in his mid-40s. This is his fifth or sixth. He was in the second draft of the regiment. He's been around. He's seen a lot of shit. And he was actually promoted out of the ranks fairly quickly. And he was a captain and had his own company for a long time. And he, for whatever reason, which will become apparent, I'm sure, during the story. Well, I know the reason, but I'm not telling the rest of the reason. He resigned his commission and went back to being a marksman. And that's why he's so old and still a frontliner. He refuses promotion.
So he's basically like a grizzled old, seen everything, done everything.
I know how those kind of stories goes. He overdosed on cocaine, and then when he was backing out of the driveway, he ran over his own daughter and wife. And now he's like trying to pay back society with his deeds in the army. Am I right?
No, not quite.
What? I was thinking you were going for the true detective setup.
No, not quite. No, but he was an officer, so, but he resigned his commission. Due to reasons.
Which will become clear if he wishes to tell you.
Yes, whether we bump into another type of character or not. He doesn't get along well with commissars.
Can Philip get a shot, by the way? Can Philip, like, order a commissar to shoot us?
No, we wouldn't be able to order a commissar. Commissars stand.
But can he order us to be, like, executed?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Philip, please don't execute me. Love you long.
Why would I execute
you? Yeah, there'd have to be good reason, but...
Commissars are officers. We're... Philip's a non-commissioned officer.
Yeah, so if you think of it as like a squad leader rather than a...
I don't think I would have the authority to have somebody executed. I would just, you know, I would have the authority to have others restrain you if there's something like afoot, and then I can report to the higher ups and they will decide, right?
Yeah.
Well, to be honest, if you get on the wrong side of a commissar, they've got the right to just shoot you there and then.
Yeah, make an example.
Yeah, exactly. Right, okay. So, I'm just trying to actually find something just to have a bit of a joke about what you said a minute ago, Philip, but I can't seem to find it. Because there is actually drugs that you can get in this game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there is. There's. Where are they? They're in under. I think they're in
armory. Right, so there's different kinds. So I think cocaine would be the equivalent of a slot, probably.
That sounds nice.
Or friendzone, one of the two.
Friendzone.
So slot is also known as onslaught. This drug heightens awareness and improves reaction time, literally speeding up the user but causing fatigue and neural damage with wrong juice. I think that's the closest thing to cocaine.
Yeah.
The stuff like obscuring.
High rage.
So
it induces rage, which is probably why he ran over his family in the first place.
Yeah, and there's things like obscura, which is basically heroin, low sticks, which are just cigarettes.
Spook.
Spook is. Yeah, Spook's LSD. Friendzone, I would say...
Oh, I smoked glow sticks then. Because my character has a cigar.
Friendzone is basically...
A cigar then.
Bath salts.
Best reconnaissance unit ever. It's like, put out a cigar. It's like, why?
Solid Snake did it, so...
Yeah, I guess.
I just tell you haven't seen those. Have you not played Metal Gear, Sergeant Cobra?
Yeah,
let me tell you how I got my name. They used to call me Snake.
Yeah, they call me some other form of Snake. Cool, so that's all our guys introduced. Right, I suppose I better introduce you to the storyline then, so I will move you to the next point. I'm just going to start.
Sick.
This is a pretty large image. So, Holy Terror, if you don't already know, is basically Earth. And the 40K universe is set in the Milky Way. We are drawing particular attention to the northwest, where it's zoomed in on the Spinwood front.
In Halo.
Yeah, just on the border of the Halo Stars. So, the Spinwood Front, it's a pretty much war-torn area. So, a lot of the worlds in the Spinwood Front are either in a perpetual state of war or at risk of invasions, attacks, or just generally death worlds, which this particular world that you'll be focusing on, Skryn, is a death world. The area that Skryn is located, it's in an area with a lot of orc activity, and Skryn itself has always had a history of orcs. They can't seem to get rid of them. Every 40, 50 years or so, they'll resurge. 150 years or 200 years, they seem to resurge and come back in new. And if you know anything about orcs, they're basically like mushrooms, so you can't really get rid of them because you can't kill all of the spores.
They're like herpes.
Yeah, or herpes, that's another good analogy.
Can't get rid of them.
So Skryn itself, it's a death world. It's highly populated by jungles with all myriads of sorts of monsters, orcs. Generally not a really nice place to live. And it was only sufficient in that there was some rare materials on Skryn that was found in the jungle.
Is it rare Optanium?
It doesn't actually specify, it just says rare and valuable goods hidden in the jungles of Skryn. That could be anything ranging from rare metals to
cukes,
all sorts of things
orcs.
Like that. What was that?
Nothing.
So basically they scraped by because they could get hold of certain valuable resources. The only reason that there was a purpose to have human life on there was, well, there wasn't really a reason. It was just a case of they got by. There's no strategic value. However, about 200 years ago, there was last 10 years, there was a expedition by Rogue Trader House who found that there was actually huge stocks of promethium on the planet. And they managed to start tapping it and refining the promethium. Promethium is basically just crude oil.
Smoke a cigar next to it.
And the administratum deemed that the world's promethium stocks, once they actually analysed how much they were, could fuel the Spinwood Front for up to 2 decades. So obviously quite a strategical asset to get hold of there. So the Rogue Trader House of Gibrahan set up a contract with the planetary governor to begin mining and selling the goods, which obviously brought the world of Skryn into a bigger repute, so there was actually a reason to be there. Fortunately, that drew the attention of the orcs in the system, and one of the local wars decided that he wanted in on it. With the resurgence of the orcs on the actual planet itself and the attack from the interplanetary orcs, the planet was suffering a little bit. And they called for help from the local, I can't remember what the word is, was it? The local Militarium General. But all of the requests were blocked, so they were basically left on their own for a long, long time until they were nearly wiped out. So there's only 100, 200,000 people left on the planet now alive. Eventually, they did offer a response, but they extorted the promethium supplies. So basically said, yeah, we'll help you, but in reward we're going to take X amount of promethium that's there, so you'll no longer be able to make the money off of it that you wished. However, we'll still be taking it. So they sent the Brontian Long Knives regiment to I don't think they sent the full regiment, they sent a few battalions of the Brontian Long Knives to support the planetary defence. That wasn't enough, however, and it soon got worse and worse, and they needed more support. So the same thing happened, and they've signed now the 501, a full regiment has been assigned to help with the cleanse of Skryn and to secure Skryn's resources against the war boss. So that's why you've come into the system. Now, a lot of this information, a lot of those details you probably wouldn't know. All you know is that you'll be landing, and the landing will actually be in a hot area.
Going in hot!
Yeah.
Black Hawk down!
Normandy. Two of us will die when we get out of the plane.
So the... I suppose, like, would you guys have mingled much while you were in transit?
Well, I mean, if people like to hang out and just, you know, kick back, yes, you would have met me.
We would have been bunking together, presumably, as a squad.
Yeah, what kind of interactions would you have had?
I definitely play some kind of card game.
Sam knows a fair number of ways to waste time as well. He tends to lose.
I'd play cards.
Yeah.
So you three would actually, you know, get on quite well.
And then in the corner just stalk still, Johan and Stan.
Yeah, we wouldn't.
I mean,
have
like I would probably have tried to initiate some conversation, and then as I realized that Sergeant Cobra is more interested in playing cards, I'm pretty relieved that I don't have to talk to anyone that can just play cards.
I mean, I would have talked to you because I respect how you being a stormtrooper, how well trained and how good a soldier you are. So I would respect that. So I would be polite with you and chat if you, or I wouldn't necessarily approach you for conversation. But if you asked me a question or start a chat, I would have.
Soldiers respond to them.
I mean, my starting a conversation would be pretty awkward, and like if you. I don't know, it's like, hey, how are you? I'm good, how are you? And then
no, it'd be, greetings, fellow Imperial Guardsman!
So it would be good, without any way to continue the conversation.
Right, yeah, so you basically close the conversation off without realising.
Yeah.
So he's like the anime gif that I liked earlier.
Yeah, generally to characterise how Sergeant Cobra, like, shows himself and interacts with the other troopers in his squad and in the whole regiment, is that he likes to keep a clear presence of, you know, that he's in control, so he doesn't get wasted. If he like is on a losing streak in cards or dice, he just stops playing. Like, he likes to maintain like conversation with most of his subordinates. I don't know if their squads are already like set or whatever, but he has like, I would say, good relations with everyone, and he wouldn't have any quarrels or try to resolve them. Yeah.
Cool. That's fine. So, as it stands at the moment, you're a little bit. So the squad doesn't have a huge amount of camaraderie. It's just a bit. You've not forged bonds in the Pfizer battle yet.
Oh, wait. Question. So, Yuri has been on the 501 how long?
You've
been longer than me, right?
Like 25 years.
Yeah, okay, so I definitely know and respect him. And because I've been 4 years on now. What about you two guys, Ross and Johan?
Well, I've spent a long time with, so I'm like 35 or something. I've spent a long time in the admin side.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
But, so I guess I would know you too, maybe?
Maybe you'd have came and maybe I'd be on the other side of the requisition or something. You'd be like, yeah, I've got game five.
you've denied some requests.
Yeah.
we can have some flashbacks where I lost like a whole squad because of you.
It's like the DVL, is it DVM, what's it called? The drive-in place, DVL? Where you go in and this, you know, in the Monsters Inc. and there's just the queue. And then you come up and there's me behind it and I just go, denied. And I stamp it down and give it back to you.
Can we have a melter gun for the next mission? And you're like, attack? We never would give those.
Those are for the best squads only.
Yeah, so as I understand it, Ross, your character, even though he's been in the admin for so long, he's only been active for...
Yeah, just recently. So I'd have been under Cobra, like, either one battle or two battles.
Well, I just got promoted. I haven't actually... this action...
Okay, then we could have got promoted in the same... Same thing, so I haven't fought then, that's I'm green.
Well, I think that in the draft, the 7th draft, obviously there's resources that have been pulled and been assigned accordingly. So Sergeant Cobra, after the 7th draft, got his sergeant's position and he's got his first team. Step, as you were moved from admin to active, duty, you were put under Sergeant Cobra.
Yeah.
I just love to imagine how, like, the commander's like, so, I have an announcement to make today. Seb from Admin is going to join us in the armed forces. Okay, sorry, go on.
And I think Yuri's just a bit of a... So, if you've ever worked in, like, an office environment, you have the guy that no one wants to manage because he's just awkward and difficult.
Yep, that's me.
That's Yuri. So he kind of gets turfed around from team to team, and he's been passed into Sergeant Cobra's team just as a bit of a test to see how you deal with, you know, a grizzled and veteran soldier.
Sure thing.
Or maybe just because, like, he couldn't complain about it because he's a brand new sergeant, and all the other sergeants are like, sweet, we can pawn him off.
Yeah, pretty much. So they've gone, oh, great, there's a new sergeant here, let's shift Yuri over.
Yeah. Yeah, that sounds about right. I mean, don't be wrong, like, I respect orders, like, I'm not insubordinate or anything.
No.
But if something's going wrong, or a sergeant's making a bad decision, then I'll let them know that they're making a bad decision.
This is shit.
Have fun, Philip.
Yeah.
And my comrade that I've came across, my comrade, he's been my spotter for the last five or six, like, the last kind of few years. So I get on really well with my comrade.
Yeah, I suppose at this point you could introduce your comrades and make sure you guys know who's who.
Yes,
so, okay, so
I'm going to start.
You don't have a comrade, do you?
My comrade is non-existent. Because, really doesn't mingle well, very well with other people. Mainly because she's like a really well-trained soldier. And she's like,
we don't need no
man. Yeah.
About this maneuver, and the other people are like, what the fuck are you talking about?
So my comrade is called Bess, and she was the cooking dinner lady at in the administration. And the same draft, we kinda did something of a fling together. Two middle-aged people kinda saw a bit of romance inside the Imperial Guard administration. You know, we made some love in the Death World, looking out over the black abyss of barren landscape outside of the hive. Oh, and we end up thinking, you know what, it'd be kind of romantic together if we could get in. But it was just bed talk, you know, because we're adults. We're not really public about our relationship. It's just something we're having, like, a laugh about. But then the draft happened, and we both get caught up in the hype around the regimency, and we ended up on the same squad. And she's my comrade, Bess and Sep.
So that's something else for you to deal with as a sergeant.
But we're really not publicly romantic at all. Like, you might not even know.
Yeah, then everybody knows it.
Yeah, yeah, you probably see us, like, sneak off the cupboard or something. Like, two middle-aged people,
soldier.
She's kind of pudgy.
It's one of those where it's, nobody knows.
Correctly. No, she's a dinner lady.
So, Sergeant, what's your comrade?
My comrade is Roland. He's, he just got drafted because my previous comrade got offed in the last mission. Well, I guess because I just got promoted, I don't know if I had a comrade, so to speak, before. Right?
So I suppose in that case, he'd just be... So your squad is generally like 10,
okay.
up to 10 guys, so he's probably just someone from the squad.
Yeah, so it's Roland. He is...
It's Roland.
Red hair, pale guy, freckles, glasses, looks like a comms guy, you know. Like one of those guys in the back who says, oh, look out over there! You know, and he in the battlefield, he's quite timid and careful, which makes him useful to me because I don't like my people dying. And he has the nickname Silver because he gambles a lot. Like around camp, he's the complete opposite of me. If I have a losing streak, I just stop. If he has a losing streak, he plays so long till he wins again. Even if that means like having 2-0-5 ogrens, like I don't know what the currency is or whatever. Like a lot. Yeah.
That's fun. Yeah. I mean, your comrades, they're only supposed to be like secondary characters, so they don't need to flesh out much at all, really.
Yeah. He's a lively person, so it's going to be sad if he's gone.
And sorry, back to you, Yuri. You were the guy that brought this up, so you might as well introduce your comrade.
Yeah, so my comrade has been around for a few years as well. He's an older soldier. He's been my spotter for the last few years. He's called Arthur, and he's a fairly sensible chap. He doesn't he's a practical person. He's very good at weighing up risks and things like that. So he's a bit like me in that sense.
So basically,
wait, he is very good.
If he wanted to be, he could be a tactician. He'd be a fairly good tactician.
Okay, I like having capable people around.
Yeah, but that's why I've kind of kept him around, because he's a smart. He's not a reckless person.
Look, Bess makes fantastic mac and cheese. Okay, I won't hear a word against Bess. Not the best fighter, okay, but mac and cheese.
The two exact opposites, like Yuri and his partner, and Seven what the best.
Yeah.
So you've been in transit for quite some time now. You've eventually come into the system, the Spinwood Front. So as you deploy to your landing ships, you see a big mill of activity. You see commissars giving the word of the Emperor. The NCOs and COs talking with each other, making sure everyone knows what's happening. As far as you're aware, you're due to land at a supply station as a battalion. So it's not just yourself, there's probably about maybe 200, 300 soldiers that are with you. Okay. So you'll get onto the landing craft, however, you're like one of the last squads onto the landing craft. So you're first at the doors, basically.
Why we're last, huh, Cobra? Whose fault was
that?
Yeah,
it's simply just because Cobra's lazy and doesn't get us moving quickly enough.
No, I don't think it was my decision at all, right?
No, you're really lazy.
I gotta make a roll, guys. Like, I'm lazy. I'm so lazy. I always try to find the, I always try to be the guys in the back lines and the one to be who survives, right?
Right.
I'm no hero.
So your actual, you are due to be at the very entrance to the landing craft. Like, that's your assigned position in the regiment. Oh, sorry, in the battalion. However, if you want, like, you can try and grease up the logistics department to try and get your squad further in, or it's up to you.
If I see uneasiness with my troops. I mean, as far as I'm concerned, we are not going to go straight out in battle, right? We are just moving to some point and get offloaded there and take positions and get our assignments.
Supply depot Gamma 29, I think it's the designation. Let me just double check. Yeah,
that sounds very safe, actually.
Supply depot Gamma 29, which is basically a fortified location as a landing stage for all military forces. So as far as you're aware, it should be.
Spoilers. Yeah. We're gonna get shot, aren't we? It's not gonna go well.
I say to the men that are seeming kind of uneasy, it's like, don't worry, men. This is only transport to the next facility. It's not like we're going to war or anything.
What?
So get in line and calm down.
The famous campaign, only transport.
Even though we know we're going to supply, or we've been told we're going to supply station, I still get my gear ready as if we're dropping into combat. Simply because I've been around long enough to know shit goes wrong.
I'm in my slippers.
Yeah, like, I can imagine Ross's gear. Right, like,
so if you're in your slippers, a passing commissar notices and
shoots me. Yeah. That's just kick up me. No, I'm
well, like, actually, he wants execute Bessie, right? They execute.
No.
No. So if that was the case. There's probably a few times where, as you're getting your gear together, commissars probably passed by and he's picked you up on maybe a button being out of place, or where's your requisitioned uplifting primer?
Yeah, I'm probably reading up on what the station is all about and how the setup is, like, in the
you
little...
You can't read, do you?
No, Val is very well educated, actually, so... She can read and write, but it's what she'll be reading is like proper kind of military text.
Not that we can tell from looking at the front.
I'm
as we
can.
Well,
what the PlayStation's design is. Or not.
Wow, Johan.
So,
you offended him.
We just like look at Val, and on the front cover is just like, we can't obviously understand it, so we just assume she's like...
It's like the Bible.
Yeah, or she's enjoying herself with some 50 Shades of Grey.
What is this holy bibble you are reading?
Holy bibble.
Holy bibble.
Alright guys, we've got to keep on the video for however long
this
is.
So, just for flavour, I mean, Sergeant Cobra usually has Roland go around and keep people in line. While he's sitting at the back, I guess at the front, you know, next to the exit. Eyes up people, looks for conversation, like, yeah.
Yeah. Good,
sorry, I was muted, yeah, that's my bad. Is there any other questions that you've got before you board the landing craft?
Yeah. Okay,
yes, good question.
We have in our regiment kit a primer or instructional handbook. What's a primer?
Yeah, so the uplifted primer is basically the Imperial Guardsman's handbook.
Okay.
And there's like tutorials how to clean your weapons and shit.
So all pictures for Death Warrant.
Yeah, so it's like a really generic kind of soldier's kind of handbook.
It's like what you find on a flight, like in the back, the safety.
Yeah,
I would probably be reading the chapter about supply depots. Not that I already know it, but it's like, well, maybe I'm missing something. Maybe I want to introduce myself in the proper way. What is the proper introduction that I'm reading up? Like,
hello, my name is Val.
And I'm like
hello, supply word, supply depot.
I'm like a little annoyed that they don't have the proper. The proper names are not listed anywhere, or that this very specific question I have is not in the book. And
how many times are you meant to how many loop your shoelaces in supply depots? Why does it not say?
Yeah.
It's over the night.
In combat gear, or is it? Do we have a uniform?
Right. So basically, what's happening? Everybody except I guess Val is going crazy because she doesn't know what she's have to expect. And I'm just trying to stay calm and hope nothing goes wrong, right?
Yeah, well, as far as you're aware, it should just be a routine landing.
Yeah, I mean, everybody loves a routine landing going right?
Yeah, I guess I would like come up to Sergeant Cobra and say, like, Sergeant, sir.
What is it, soldier?
Do we go out in our uniform or in our armor?
What are we? Are we wearing uniform or armor, Scott?
Well, you'll notice that this is the regiment's first landing, so as they're landing, the commander wants to make an impression upon the Bronte and Long Knives and the Planetary Defence Force. So, you'll be in full dress.
Full
combat attire.
Okay, so we're doing like Russian parade style.
Yeah, I
like go out of the door and then I come back in. What about our weapons? Should we take our weapons with us, or is it rude if we show them?
No, yeah, you'll be taking your weapons with you.
Well,
the commander wants to make an impression,
you know,
show our worth, so we will be representing us.
Just saying, by the way, if the commander wants us all really to show off, then we definitely have our walker.
And I'm like,
only ever make.
Well, we're not at that point yet, Russ. I mean, right now we have basically everything.
No, so the landing craft is like it's a platoon landing craft, so it's not actually if you imagine your vehicles would get dropped on specifically designated vehicles.
Oh, I see, okay.
You'll notice as well from dress uniform, like where everybody's got like one or two medals and like beading and things to show their campaign. I've got like the entire chest full. Like the entire left hand side of my chest is just filled with beading and like medals, and there's like special. So as part of your kind of rank insignia, I suppose, like I've got a designated marksman.
Looks like this guy.
So like not quite. But let me see if I can find.
Oh, did I misunderstand?
Philip, I would probably at some point head back in into your room and be like, no, that would be stupid. We don't go gun blazing. And then I head back out without asking an answer.
He shoots the guy's opening. Welcome to the.
Anyway, so
look like a North Korean general. I've just googled this. This is ridiculous. This guy's got medals going down the top of his trouser legs. He's got so many.
You got a link?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, you're no commissar, so.
No, so I mean, ostentatious displays are usually frowned upon, but due to obviously Yuri's length of service, the commissars are.
Oh, it's full dress uniform. It's
yeah,
you have to wear.
They look like scout boy scouts.
Like he's got medals on his trouser leg. All right, okay, so it's not like full, like proper dress uniform. It's full combat gear.
Yeah, it's like military.
It's to look good, and like it's going to be on TV.
Yeah, it's like a show of power to the residents. Yeah, to the people of the planet.
Oh, right, in that case... Then
space troopers have arrived! Stay safe in your home!
Sorry, I mistook what we're wearing. No, okay then, I would just have my designated marksman band on then.
Okay. Right, so in that case then, I suppose with a little bit of coercion, Kev manages to get the guys on board. Yeah. Cool. So as you actually get into the landing craft itself, it's, you know, it's how big it is. You can actually probably fit two full battalions in. At the moment it's just what your battalion you're part of, so 200 to 300 soldiers. There is some gaps in the seatings, but generally most people are shoulder to shoulder with another man or woman.
Mm-hmm.
Everything that you kind of have on yourself is fixed to you. You have to sit in the seats. I imagine they're like roller coaster seats, but any heavy weapons or packs are stowed kind of below, out of the way. I suppose at this point.
Okay, it's not a heavy weapon.
Not the gun isn't a heavy weapon. Heavy weapons are things like your heavy stubbers, things like that.
Cool. I don't think any of us have any heavy weapons.
So, I mean, how would you guys be dealing with the kind of anticipation?
I'm a consoling base. I'm telling her, don't worry about it. We'll be fine. Praise the Emperor.
Is there anything in particular you'd say?
Praise the Emperor.
Right, just as you actually start to praise the Emperor.
I say the Emperor watches over his base.
The engines blare and kick into gear. When they kick into gear, like, even if you were screaming at the top of your voice, the person next to you will be able to hear anything. So, midway through your sentence, it just cuts out and you can't hear a thing. It doesn't stop the commissars from walking around and bellowing obscenities and generally demeaning the soldiers. You can't quite tell what they're saying, but you get the occasional word, the mix of Emperor, Will, Purge the Unclean. just from the lip reading.
I kind of pull my cap down over my eyes and have a quick nap.
Yeah, and as you take off and you feel the force of the landing craft exit the gravitational pull of the starship, the lights dim, goes like a red, murky light. You can barely see each other. That's obviously so there's no profile in space. And you feel the spaceship enter the atmosphere. Seems like a fairly standard landing. However, about maybe half a kilometer or so from the landing point, you feel what is kind of like turbulence, but a heavy turbulence.
As in being hit by rockets or something.
No, you won't necessarily know. It's like it's just you feel the landing craft shake up and down as if it's hitting some pretty bad turbulence.
The Emperor Gage!
I'm just sitting there and saying, hold!
30 seconds!
And there is something that...
Go!
The comms system glare a little bit, a lot of static. There is some words being said, but what I need you all to do is make a Perception. Difficult awareness test for me.
How does difficult work?
So this will be our first test, I guess. So
good thing we're all trained in awareness.
No, I'm super trained in awareness.
Right, so difficult would be a minus 10.
Okay, so we just pressed awareness and then minus 10.
Yeah.
Wow, Yuri. Right. Yuri was asleep.
Yeah, man. I told you that.
Wow, fucking on point.
Right, so pretty much all of you failed. Yuri is completely unawares. But as Alex said, he's probably asleep at this point.
Wait,
I didn't fail. Did I fail?
Wow.
You have to presumably have to roll under your number.
Yeah.
I rolled a 97.
Yeah, so that was like nearly a critical fail. If you've got a crit fail, you're like, all right, that's it, we're landing. Straight out.
Get him out of your system now, Alex. It will be good for you. Detox a little.
Yeah. Right, so pretty much everyone can't understand it or they're choosing not to listen, apart from Val, who hears the ship's pilots informing the passengers that the landing zone has become hot, so it's a combat landing. It's going to be orcs currently attacking the depot, so you'll be landing in the midst of an attack on the depot. Only Val's heard that, though, out of you guys.
Would I assume that everybody heard that and that I should head to the...
I don't know, would you assume that?
Well, you look around, you see Yuri sleeping. Sam is probably holding hands with Beth.
Yes,
I'm just, twirling my thumbs.
Roland's just chillaxing.
Yeah, so it's obvious that a lot of the soldiers have heard something on the Tannoy. It's just asked if they know what he said, they don't. So it's obvious that the Tannoys were being played, but with the noise of the engines and the turbulence that's shaking you about.
I unholster my weapon. I'm like, Sand Cobra, what? Then I notice that the engines are super loud and nobody can understand anything.
So I suppose if you're going to shout something...
Don't we have Fox? Oh no, we don't have Fox.
No.
We don't have comm beads, do we?
No. So you can shout something, but I'll need whoever you're shouting to take an awareness test to see if they understand.
Write us a note! Oh wait, can't read.
What do you shout then?
Sand Cobra, what are your orders? We have to go to the landing, through the exit immediately.
Right, so that's what you scream. Same test again, please. Philip?
You could have just said landing zone is hot, Sergeant.
Minus 10.
I mean, I don't know that he hasn't heard it. I assume heard it, because I'm like...
There you go.
I heard it. I shouldn't assume that my superior hasn't heard it.
Right, so you miss a few words, but you get the general gist of what he's saying there.
Why did he miss a three? Why did he roll a two?
No, all I'm saying is he doesn't miss, like, it's...
Oh,
I
see, oh, okay, yeah, okay.
He gets
basically
what you say,
rolled a two.
So when Val says that, I see, like, some agitation in her face or something. I look around and I probably see other groups of people reacting in the same fashion, right?
Yeah, some... You'd probably see that some guys are obviously getting a bit prepared, others are like Yuri, and they're completely unawares.
Okay, do I see the commissars? Do they? I mean, they should be running around
so,
sending orders, right?
No, when you were in orbit and you were entering the atmosphere, they were basically doing like the flight wardens, you know, just...
Here was
here.
Yeah, exactly. Pointing out, make sure everyone's aware, make sure everyone's praising the Emperor.
So the commissars are walking around, right? So that means I should
get
up as well, right?
So during the landing, because of the turbulence, it's like when you land in a plane, there's no one walking around, everyone's strapped in.
Well, I just... I try to get the men to attention. I don't know where Yuri is, but I say... attention. So I try to get, we do the
right. So we've already established
elbow knocking the your neighbor kind of stuff, right?
Yeah. So we've established that Val can hear you perfectly fine. You reset because now it's Sergeant Cobra making the noise. If you could roll the same test. Yeah. No, not you, Val. You're already in communication.
We have established communication.
Archer is still Sokom.
Yep. Slightly more aware than
I was. Oops, sorry, before. I clicked the wrong thing.
73.
Yay!
Right, so Set does understand that you're trying to get an attack, you know, get his attention, but can't quite hear what you're saying.
But I'm paying attention now because it's a success.
Yeah, it's a success. You'll get, like, major words, but there'll be a lot of stuff that you do miss over the noise of the engine.
What?
So I get out my last pistol and I say, ready weapons, and then I just start, you know, checking my
weapon. Yeah,
safety.
That's a
and
weapon.
Then I get out my chainsaw and do the same.
So what Sep hears there is, instead of ready weapons, he hears heavy weapons.
No! Downstairs. The heavy weapons are down in the hold.
How does it work? Do I just command him to...
But you're hearing perfectly fine, because you're running really well. Sep isn't, so...
You just have to keep shouting at me until I get it.
Okay, so I just repeat the order. Make yourselves ready, the landing zone is hot. I repeat, the landing zone is hot. We're going in guns blazing.
Yourself is hot? Yeah! Yeah! Guys, no! No! Sergeant! No! Don't
so
go that way!
Back and forth. Eventually, Sep, you do kind of notice
that people
are readying the weapons.
Okay. No, I
Why does Rust's character always feel like this weird foreigner who doesn't understand a lot? And he's like, oh, hello, my
I'm sorry. The opening scene is with a loud engine noise, particularly difficult to understand.
I would probably stand at the door, like, look out. About to run to the exit and then look back in, staying with my team.
Yeah, so I help Besk air weapons out and I get one. I hook it.
Yeah, so basically this entire time you are still fixed heavily into the seats.
Yeah.
So who's sitting next to Yuri? Because someone nudge him awake.
That'd be Yuri's comrade.
Who's sitting next to Yuri's comrade?
Just another guy from the squad.
Yeah, so what I was doing is just generally like getting the attention of the squad and, like, you know, tapping knees and telling people to pass on messages.
Slap them in
so
the face.
Everybody's informed.
Wake them up.
Yeah, so
because our arms are not restricted, right?
No, yeah. So because Val and Sergeant Cobra are aware they're already, eventually the message does get passed down to you.
Wonderful.
So I suppose you'd all be getting ready. Is there anything that you guys would need? So you guys don't have heavy weapons here.
We have one heavy weapon, which would be a flamethrower or something.
Yeah, but your squad, your squad doesn't have any, do they?
Oh no.
No.
That's fine. So as you, as the turbulence gets worse and worse, you start to hear the kind of crack and bellow of frack. Flak. Yeah, so flak as if, you know, they were trying to take you down in orbit.
I feel pretty confident because I got a plus one against flak.
You got a plus one against frag.
Yeah, grenades.
Yeah.
No. Yeah. Armor's called flak.
But the shuttle's largely, as far as you can tell, you know, it's hitting its course fine. It's not taking too much damage or being deterred by the flak. That is until you land, and you can tell it's not a soft landing. It's very fast, hard landing.
Nice.
I need you all to make for me a athletics test, minus 10.
Where's athletics?
Yeah.
That's not gonna be good.
I've not passed a single test yet.
That's good.
We only rolled three.
I've totally
failed.
Yep.
Right, so you all fail. So those who fail a test suffer 1d5 impact damage. So
wow.
Oh, is that for all of us?
Yeah. So basically, as you've landed, it's landed with that much force and violence that you've basically been rattled about in your chairs as if you were like stone in a cup. So you're all taking 5 damage off your wounds.
Okay.
There we go. Armor.
However, yeah, it is reduced by armor.
So
okay.
One damage.
Yeah, sorry. If I have 6 armor.
Yeah, you'd be fine.
Okay.
So you all get shook about like a ragdoll and Bowser's like.
So we've got flak armor. No, we don't have flak armor. We've got flak vests.
No, no, we have flak armor.
No,
we've
got flak armor.
No, I have stormtrooper carapace.
No, according to our standard regimental kit, we don't.
I swear you changed it, didn't you?
Oh, yeah, yeah, but I think in the regimental thing it still says flak vest, but we do have flak armor. Protects the whole body for full armor.
Wait, does toughness come off as well?
That's my bad. That no, toughness doesn't come into play on this one.
Okay, just armor.
Just armor. Yeah, that's my bad, Alex. I didn't put that on the standard regimental.
No, that's fine.
Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, so you get bashed about a little bit. It's nothing too bad, unless
Weez.
Someone, yeah.
Weez 11 kilos, by the way.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's not too heavy. Obviously, the weight's spread around.
Yeah.
Anyway, so as you land, the door flies open at that point, and as you guys obviously aware, you are closest to the door. So let me move you over now to the first map. It is a fairly big map, so I'll warn you. You'll have to zoom out.
Whoa.
Let me move you guys over as well, so you've got your tokens.
I can see orcs in the bottom right corner.
Orcs? This big?
Yeah, yeah,
they look
orcs,
like
are
like,
orcs. Orcs are big. They're big, big aliens.
Big ones.
Cool. Did map. I like you've got the crashed plane.
I am trying to move your tokens over, just give me one moment.
Did you make that map?
Yep.
That's really good.
Really?
Yeah.
Awesome, man.
Here you are then. I'll let you guys pop yourself in.
Okay, so where's the exit of
the
vehicle? The
exit, it's kind of hard to show you, but do you see there's like a ramp that's underneath there? Yeah, where Seth stood now. Yeah, that.
Okay, Val and I take point.
Yeah, I'm like behind. Is this a rock that's actually on the ground?
You are, so, we are still
at the moment, yeah, at the moment you're just exiting the landing craft, so.
You are already fucking running a mile away.
Yeah, but.
So basically, do you see how the width of the craft is from like there to like there? That's the entire ramp.
Okay.
So it's like the entire side of the craft's gone and opened like a big door.
Oh no, guys! There's fire! It's exploded!
Also, Scott, should our tokens be this size? Because they're like 2x2 now.
There should be two tall. Yeah, two tall.
Okay.
But only one wide?
That's just set because he's got an awkward token. Unless you want to distort him. I'll distort set for you then.
No.
Wow, you just got buff.
I know, the distances are a bit odd.
So I actually have a 4 meter ding dang dong along.
Anyway, right, so at this moment when you disembark, you can see that there is the immediate threat about 60 metres out is those orcs by the caterpillar, not the caterpillar tracks, the tank traps.
Those ones, right?
Can you see them? Yeah, they're about 60 metres away.
Wait, that's 6 metres?
60!
60, 60. Oh,
okay, sorry.
Okay.
I was like, what?
Yeah, so as you disembark, it's not just yourself disembarking, it's just I can't obviously show the rest of the platoon moving out, but the rest of the platoon is moving out to different locations.
I was expecting 300 to 200 tokens out there, Scott.
It's like the entire Roll 20 server.
Yeah.
Right, so if you could, anyone with the Tactical Imperialist lore,
yep.
Which should be Sergeant and Val, I think.
Yeah.
Don't know if Yuri and Sepp have got it.
Yeah.
Lore.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
It's Scholastic Tactica Imperialis.
No.
No. Nope. Right, so both of you make a +10 test, right?
Hmm?
Right, I need you both to make a +10 test, please.
Oh, shit!
Did you crit? You rolled a 1.
Did you,
Oh my god, and you had to get 0 and you still failed. Wait, what? That's not right. How do you have to get 0?
What?
So, yeah, I don't know how that's worked.
You fucked up, Johan.
I didn't.
Wait, I rolled what?
You had to get 0 too. Why are you guys having to roll against 0? What are you guys pressing? Why are you guys rolling against 0?
Yeah, which button are you pressing?
The one next to Tactica Imperialis, like the button on the left.
Worked for me.
No, yeah, that's supposed to work, yeah.
I'll try again. Plus 10, right?
Yeah.
I wasted a 4 right there.
I just rolled it there for, it's still rolling as a 0, that's weird.
But I rolled a 1, so I know what happened.
And I rolled an 8, so I know too.
Yeah, so both of you do know. I don't know why that's broken. Yes, both of you can tell that as you've landed, the orcs have a significant numerical advantage over the defenders. Without immediate action from the 501, the defenders will be overrun. Okay, what are you making of that? Are you just thinking,
all right. Well, I guess they're going to get overrun.
As we leave the craft, I kind of take up a knee and start scanning the area anyway. And just, Sergeant, what's your orders?
Yeah, I go, snipers, ready to fire. Take positions and hold them off. Yeah. Wait further instructions and then I take cover.
Scott,
so we clear the landing way, right? And there's like, what kind of cover is there? Trenches, like
right,
less
so
from
between you and the runt herds, the only cover you've got is the trenches that's been created by the landing craft.
Mm-hmm.
That large boulder to the front that the landing craft has narrowly missed, but then it's hit the other one. And then between that and the runt herds, there is no cover.
So should we shoot the orcs?
No, I say take cover.
Okay.
Snipers get ready. Because it's quite the distance, and we're all sniper rifles.
60
right?
meters, we have 200 meters range. 60.
Yeah.
We could destroy them.
Yeah, that's what I said, but take cover first, because they're going to shoot you.
So is there anything else that you guys are wanting to look at?
Well,
or
can I shoot awareness or something to check out the area? How does it work?
No, you tell me.
Well, I want to look around and see if there's any kind of tactical advantage I can gain from the area.
Well, so basically what's happened is as a landing craft has come in, you've had a hard landing, but then the front of the landing craft is plowed into effectively a small cliff, and you can see the landing craft has taken a lot of damage.
Okay, so you can't put a plus into the modifier?
Right,
if it's
so that's what's
it's
breaking
10,
it.
Yeah.
Oh, so we just put
10. Oh, so you just... Alright, I get you. So you just put 10, nothing else.
If it's minus, you put...
Yeah, okay, that makes sense. So yeah, the landing craft is pretty severely damaged. And one of the engines has taken a lot of damage.
Okay, well, I take tell the snipers to open fire on the orcs by the brigades. And I guess the other squads are flowing out of the vehicle now and taking actions as well.
Do we roll initiative or something?
Yeah, I suppose so, if you're not doing anything else. Now, Ross, you might want to help me out with this. How do you...
Take cover.
In fact, ignore me. I'm going to roll... All the orcs are going to roll the same initiative. Okay?
Yeah.
Fair. All right.
Where do I bring the initiative order up?
On the left, yeah, there you go.
Yeah. You'll have to tell me this one because I've never done this before, so.
Oh, you should make a max.
So, initiative is D10 plus your agility.
It's ours, plus our perception. Did I read that somewhere?
Yeah, ours is ours plus perception.
Yeah.
Do we have that, all of us?
Yep.
Combat yeah, it's a regimental thing.
Yeah, okay. So, would it be plus. Yeah.
Whatever's higher.
Yep.
And it's plus 3 rather than plus 30.
I'm just there shouting orders. Everybody else has already taken cover and shooting. Come on, sergeant. Or do we want to roll roll?
That did not work.
Hi.
Damn it.
Wait, it isn't on the sheet.
No, apparently not.
D10 plus agility.
Plus the, yeah, the decimal. So.
Yeah, yeah, that. I got the ghost tracker.
Sick.
Put that right. In. Oh, okay.
How'd you manage to get it to go to the tracker?
Put this in on Facebook. And square bracket tracker in square bracket. It sends a roll to the tracker. Make sure you're clicking your token.
Okay.
It even says my name. I don't know if you guys can see my name. Probably not.
No.
So you're all in now. Yeah. How do you order it?
You go on the cogwheel and then descending.
Cool. Alright, so I don't think it's any form of break, it's doing it, sir.
Everyone takes their turn at the same time, isn't it? I don't know.
Yeah, I think so. This is because the turns are a lot shorter, they're like 2 seconds, I think. Alright, so Yuri, you've got the first turn.
So I'm going to take some cover behind the rocks down here with my spotter, and I want to take a shot, or I want to spend the turn aiming.
So you're using your full action to aim?
Can I use a half action and still pick out of a shot?
Yeah, so your half action is aim, I think, and then it's half action to shoot, if I'm not incorrect.
Alex,
have you
registered that we have a tracker as well, so we get plus 10 shots?
Targeter.
Yes,
targeter.
God.
Yeah.
Is running in a half action too?
Running is a full action. So if you want to run your full distance, it's full action.
And if we take cover?
You just take cover by getting into it.
But so you have to move to take cover?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you have to use an action to move.
Yeah.
Okay. So half action to move or half action to
it's
aim?
It's half action to move, half action to aim.
Cool, that's fine. I'll, that's
what distance can we run?
18 meters.
Oh, nice.
I think.
Yeah, I'll say in your sheep.
Yeah, that's underneath, just above your armor.
So it says half move 3, full move 6, charge 9, run 18.
3 meters.
So 3 meters only.
No, full move is your half.
What's half move then?
I don't know.
6. I think.
So you can move 6, Alex, without moving.
Yeah.
No, 6 is a full move, so half move is 3.
Yeah, but we can't go into cover this turn.
You can just lie down, I guess.
Yeah, you'd have to run to get into cover, Alex.
Yeah. Oh, okay then. I'll just take cover behind part of the...
Yeah, but if you run, you do get a benefit to them shooting here.
Yeah, but I want to start aiming. That's my thing. I want to start aiming this turn.
Alright, okay, so you're prepping to shoot.
Yeah.
So
that's
these...
fine, I'll take... I'll just kneel down behind some debris of the ship. That kind of thing. Or I'll go prone and use my tripod.
Right, so Yuri's moving and aiming?
Yeah, so I'll move into a light bit of cover in the wreckage.
Yeah.
Rather than go behind the rocks.
Right, okay, so the Gretchens, they can't move very far, to be honest, so they're little buggers. So the Gretchens are like little goblins. They obviously see you and make headway. The Brunt Herds, which are they're basically the shepherds, the ones that are booting the Gretchens about, you do see them physically abusing them to get them moving, though. they run a little bit faster, but they do stay behind the Gretchens anyway. So just move.
So they're, are they running?
Yeah, they're running. So for you to shoot at them now, it's a harder target to hit.
Okay. What are they wearing?
Loincloths.
The grunters. Are they?
The Gretchens, they've got nothing on. They're just basically wearing a bit of a loincloth, that's about it.
Mm-hmm. And the bosses?
The Grunt Herders, they are wearing same kind of stuff, but they do have a flak vest on as well.
Okay.
Looks like they've nicked it from somewhere, so it's kind of, it's not actually made for their size, it's just kind of stuck on.
Okay. Okay. My turn.
Did you move far?
Yeah, he did. You can't move very far to move because you only get to where it is six. I would like to cold shot his head.
What, cold shot the
Grinners?
Right, so what benefits and minuses do you get from that again?
So I get minus 20 from being a cold shot, but I've got dead eye shots, so it's only a minus 10.
Right.
And I get minus 20 from him running, but
yeah.
I get plus 10 because I got a Targar. So minus 20.
Good luck with that.
So I don't think we're going to hit. Oh no, can I take... No, I can't take a half action team, right?
No, because you're cold shot.
Cold shot, yeah.
Okay, so damage.
Oh shit, I should use the weapon roll, but whatever. Doesn't matter, still a roll. Hit. No modifier in the hit, right? Oh no, that's the roll to hit. Wrong clone. 11 damage.
Which one was it you shot?
The grunter, the one closest, and the head, so he doesn't get slack based.
Just need to actually check something real quick.
This one right here.
Sorry, I just need to check.
Oh my god, I can't believe that worked. I shot him in the head. I rolled a 10. So,
well, I thought you know it's not just killing.
Yeah, I have 1 degree of success, so I think that gives me something.
Have you ever seen this one?
Yeah.
Does it taste any good?
It's okay. Scream so
that. That's fine, that doesn't come into play.
God, you're really quiet.
I know, he's so quiet, right?
Right, so how much damage was it?
I was 11 pain free and I got 1 degree of success.
Right, so 11 didn't have any armor that you can pen, so.
Yeah, because I shot him in the head.
Yep. He had 1 degree of success, so there's no extra damage.
Don't I pain for his toughness? Is that not what that means?
No. Toughness is always applied no matter what.
No, a base armor isn't even higher than 3, so that was a waste of fucking cold shot, whatever.
So you do hit him in the head, that's fair enough. However, it kind of looks like you've just kind of flicked him a little bit. So it's a solid hit.
It's like right in the middle, stuck there, but it doesn't really look like it's done any harm.
So it did hit quite hard, so it's whipped his head back, but he doesn't want to taste or anything.
Roll for whiplash!
Was it the bottom one that you said?
Yeah, that guy, yeah, that's right, the one you just pinged there.
Okay. Oh, there's
something
on my
feedback
there.
What's that?
Someone's hissing.
I think Johan is trying to get his sound.
Yes, sorry.
Oh, you're like
Will it work better?
Yep.
Yeah, we can hear you really well, but if you're going silent, we can hear your radiator.
Ah, great.
Exactly how I planned it.
Good old times.
I move it to quiet.
So what does the degrees of success do? I
should be better now.
I'm just going to double check that. This is the way I think we might get bogged down a little bit in the combat.
Degrees of success is page 30. Because I remember it used to get me extra hits. And I was a devastator. I think that was because I was firing auto. Yeah.
Right, so you didn't get a 10 on damage, did you?
I got a 10 on the roll, so that's 1 degree of success.
Yeah, no, I was checking for damage.
Damage got no. I got 7+4. Page 30. Degrees of success. Making if the roll is equal. Furthermore, every 10 grants another degree of success. Great. Doesn't.
But I think. Degrees of success only apply when you're using the type of shot that comes off of it, so...
I think it means it's the minimum damage on the roll. I think that's what it means, if I remember right.
Degrees of success with, like, fully automatic shots...
Yeah.
Gives you an extra shot.
Grant you more hits against the target.
Yeah.
But I think on degrees of success is, for single weapons, I think is the minimum damage you can roll on a dice, right?
Yeah.
I think that was right.
Yeah, you roll.
If you get 3 degrees of success, the minimum damage you can do is 3.
Alright.
Something like that.
Cool. Cold
Shot
doesn't have anything else to say.
Nope. I just
tells you to pick the place.
Just gets me red rays on.
Okay. So, Right, so that was your turn, Ross. Who's next?
Bass.
I am. And I mean, since I heard my sergeant orders, I'm gonna move into cover. And that's it.
Makes sense.
Yeah, okay. I mean,
oh yeah, we can still shoot from there.
How far did you move? 10 meters. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, is that all you do?
Yeah, I mean, I can't do anything else.
So you're not okay. Running? If you run, you can travel up to, what is it, 18?
And you give them a minus 20 if they try and shoot you.
Yeah.
But run would still be my full action, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so it doesn't... There's no use. I mean, if I run any further, I can't shoot over the stone.
Okay, that's fine. Okay. Sarge?
Okay, so I will expend my full movement and run to the trenches left behind by the landing ship.
Yeah, so
I'll just slide in there, and while I slide, I say, "Get in there and fight, maggots!" Yeah, that's my turn.
Yeah. Yuri, back round for you.
So I aimed last turn.
Yes.
So I get a plus 10.
Yeah.
And I'm going to take a cold shot against one of the same guy that Ross fired at.
Yeah.
Hey, Ross didn't fire anything.
Sorry, that Seth fired at. So the cold shot plus the targeter negates any negative.
If you've got Deadeye Shot, do you have Deadeye Shot?
I've got Deadeye Shot as well.
Yeah, so that plus a target makes Cold Shot free.
All of us have Deadeye Shot, by the way.
Plus my aim, so I'm taking this at a plus 10.
So just put 10, don't put a plus.
Yeah, plus 10.
Yeah, cool. Where is it?
Okay, Brandon, do you use a success to nothing?
It's only if the type
of shot. I rolled a single roll.
69, lol.
Wait, that's rolling against the wrong number.
You rolled a 69.
But that's not taking into account the plus 10 that I've got that I've spent my stats on. That's rolling that.
Yeah, you have to adjust your stats manually.
Oh, you have to adjust them manually.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Because I put I put something simple. Plus 5, do I have to just put
you have
in
to
manual?
Add 5 to your stat, yep.
Ah, okay, but down there is just a reminder that you already have it on simple, right?
Yes, because you have to spend different amounts of XP.
Okay, that's okay.
I mean, it's still not a hit.
Yeah, it's still not a hit, but...
No, but that makes... Yeah, that's fair enough, that makes sense. Cool.
Yeah. Cool, so
do we have the same ballistic score? Do you have 41?
Yeah.
Damn.
Hey, I almost have 41 too.
As the shoulder...
I have 41 as well.
You don't.
After the shot whips past the orc run herd's head, he kind of laughs a bit. Humans can't shoot.
That was after he got the shot in the head.
Yeah, they're not the brightest. They're not the brightest creatures. So yeah, it's basically goading Yuri a little bit. And they do the same thing, they move up, so... Right now, so he can't move any further at the moment. So, come on.
I will be back in a sec.
Right, so it's going to move up in Cajun again like that. And it is now Sexton.
Praise the Emperor! Guardian of Humanity guided my bolt! I'm following you, Commander, and I'm going to run into this trench. This is a trench? Yeah.
Yes. So the back one is deeper than the front one. The front one's a furrow that's been cut by the wing, whereas the back one's the one that's had the, you know, the body of the...
How deep is it?
It's big enough that you couldn't stand in it, but if you crouch down in it, you'll be in, like,
okay.
Decent cover.
Yeah, I'll crouch. And I'll grab Bess with me too, and she's shaking a bit.
It's okay, Bess. The Emperor protects.
Ross's character is not even an asset, it's just, hey, let's roleplay a little bit.
This should be assets.
Hey, what are you talking about? Oh, you mean bases?
Do I have? Do our comrades have any kind of attack or something?
Yes, they can take actions. That's what I.
But that's what your XP was for, right?
Yep. So
if you didn't pay any XP, they're useless. Right.
So because the only action I have is to, you know, make them stop being afraid.
Right. So here you go. So. Actions that you can take. So you can do a volley with an action, which will give you a +5 to ballistic skill tests. Close quarters, where it'll give you a flank, so it'll give you a benefit of ganging up in melee.
Okay.
Or take cover, it'll give.
A tail base to take cover. Because if I don't tail her, she doesn't know.
Yeah.
So every turn we get a comrade action, too.
Could you have a quick look for me and find out where cover is? Just while I'm.
Page 271, do you want me to look?
Yeah, just so I'm trying to find a few bits at the same time. Oh, I just dropped onto it actually. Yeah. So yeah, the cover that you're in now will give you a... standing in deep mud.
Yeah, okay.
What about mine?
Whereas... No, sorry, that's yours, Ross. Okay. Standing cobras as if he's just on rough road.
What's my cover?
You're in tall grass.
You're on +10.
Well, you're behind a rock, Val.
Yeah, because you're not fully behind it. You're still within, you know, like full view of the guys.
They're clearly not going to shoot us.
By the way,
bit...
are those orcs? Are those space orcs? Or are those savage orcs?
I'm back.
They just look like orcs that have looted equipment from the areas.
Okay.
Do they have fire weapons or just?
The Gretchens. The Gretchen's got little pistols and rudimentary, like, stabby, like a little shiv. The Runt Herd has a bigger pistol and a chopper. He also's got, like, a kind of like a cattle prod type thing. That
a,
a cattle prod. Yeah, so the things that you shock cows with.
Oh.
A cattle prod. So he's basically. Poking the Gretchen.
Okay. Seems nice. Cool. Whose turn is it?
Yeah, so are you not taking an aim action, not shooting? Are you doing nothing at all?
Seb is using his action to run. I mean, you can't do much more.
Yeah, yes. Safe and base run.
So oh, by the way, I gave the order to take cover to Roland, right? So he should be with me, I'd imagine.
You can just tell him to say he's with you.
Yeah, that's what I intended to do. Now that I know about the combat
action. That's not beautiful.
Yes, I'm just going to, for the sake of making it a little bit easier, you're kind of always in cohesion. We're not going to do away breaking up with your comrade. They just kind of stick by your side. So, what are you doing, Val? You're not doing anything.
No, Val! I thought you meant Sepp.
No, Sepp's moved into cover. He's...
Yeah,
he's hunkered down.
That's why I was confused that you're not... I mean, of course he's not doing anything. But, no, I'm aiming and shooting.
So, right, okay.
What does aiming give me? If I use my half action thing?
Half action's +10.
Mm-hmm.
And... your normal shot is +10 if I'm... correct.
Nope.
What if I use a semi-automatic, like a first shot?
Yeah, so standard attack +10, aim is +10. What are you trying to do, semi-auto burst?
Yeah.
Semi-auto burst has no additional BS on the attack. You'll still get it from obviously your aim. However, for every 2 additional degrees of success, you hit again.
Okay, then I'm gonna shoot my... So my modifier is +10 in total.
So you're getting +10 for your main, +10 mm-hmm. from the tracker, targeter, whatever it's called.
Does it matter on what weapon I mounted my tracker?
I'm going to say it's on your main weapon.
The main weapon is my sniper rifle or the weapon I got from my class?
You tell me.
I mean, my main weapon would probably be my last gun, since everybody else is using sniper rifles.
Right, so it's on your last gun then.
My target jumps.
So I get plus 10 from that as well.
Your targeter can't jump, bro.
No, I'm just saying.
Alright, so...
At this point, my targeter has moved weapon.
Everyone tell me what your target is on.
Last gun.
Can it be on a pistol?
If you want it to be on a pistol.
I thought we got one for each weapon.
It's on your chainsaw.
That doesn't work, does it?
No, target is like a modification, Ross, so it's only once.
Oh, I put on...
It's a difficult choice. I would imagine it's on a sniper rifle, because who
can't
has
change it?
I didn't know I could only use on one.
No, it's fine, I didn't think.
It's in the description.
Yeah.
Of what?
What the targeter is.
Like, I read that.
I
read the numbers.
I'm still a bad shot, though.
Right, that's fine. Val misses his shot. You hear some more goading and hawing from the orcs.
Hey, you can't hit a bomb.
Just keep an eye on the range, because range will come into play with benefits as well.
Okay. Here. Closing in, 40 yards.
My range is 60 feet from my...
Yeah, so basically range works how 60 foot is not your...
60 meters.
60 meters is not your top range. That's the kind of effective range for the weapon. You can shoot longer than that range. You just take a penalty for shooting at a certain range. But
not the sniper rifles, because they've got sights.
Yeah, exactly.
Because the range is 200, right?
Nope.
That's the effective range of a sniper rifle, but you can fire longer than that because of the scope.
Extreme range is up to 3 times the range of a weapon. Long range is double, and short range is half. So once they're within half the range of your weapon, you get a plus 10 to hit.
Oh, I did 2 degrees of success then.
With a sniper rifle.
I would have hit then.
Yeah, wait, so...
We get what for normal?
Because I forgot that you get the plus 10 for shooting for a standard attack, plus the 10 that I missed on the roll, plus the 10 from the within half range.
Right, no, you didn't use a standard attack, you called shots, so you didn't get the extra plus 10. So you only get plus 20 to your roll.
Oh, yes,
of course.
But
right, so
what did you roll?
You rolled a 79.
Oh, okay.
So we know about range now, so keep that in mind.
Yeah.
Right, it's now Sarge's go.
Also, okay. You can tell your comrade to help you, and you get a plus 5.
Yeah. So that's what we established once we were Alex.
Question: if the comrade starts using another action, does he lose his cover bonus? Or if I told him to go into cover before that, is he still in cover?
No, it's a full action to take cover. So they have to do it.
Yeah, so they have to take their full action to take cover.
Okay, so I guess I just tell Roland to open fire on the orc herder, or whatever they're called, and as volley or whatever it was.
Range
so
volley.
Plus 5.
To give me advantage, but to help me out.
Yeah, so you get plus 5.
Yeah, so if I have my full movement at my disposal, so... I want to take a shot with my sniper rifle, which would be within more than half range, because it's not more than 100 meters, right?
If it's within 100 meters, it's short range. If you're within, I think it's within 5 meters, you're at extreme close range, so they get a plus 30 at that range.
Remember, it's a half action to switch weapons.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna... Aiming is half action as well, right?
Yeah.
My melee doubles its pain at short range, I have to remember that.
What?
Alright, just stop cutting in.
I just want to take a shot at this guy, and I want to know what my modifiers are if I aim before that.
Right, so if you aim, you get plus 10. Taking a standard shot is plus 10. You get plus 5 from the volley fire that you get from your comrade.
Mm-hmm.
And then plus 10 from target. So your plus is 35.
Okay.
And then minus 20 because he's running it, yeah.
That's 15. Okay. Nope.
Okay, so there's some more goading.
And how much? That's my full action, right? Shooting is 2 actions? Half action? Yeah.
Aim's a half action, shooting's half action.
Hey, by the way, our sniper rifles are accurate, so they get an extra plus 10 to the aim action.
Well, it still would have missed.
So okay, Alex would have hit, because that's plus 30.
Right, we know now.
Yeah, we know now.
I knew that this would be awkward for rolling, because we...
Also, an extra D10 damage from every 2 degrees of success.
What's that for, snipers?
Anything with accurate.
Every two
only when aiming as well.
That's cool.
I've decided to read what they do.
Finally.
That's the only thing, my only criticism about this system is there's so many different modifiers coming from so many different places.
Yeah.
That makes it complicated. Cool. So is it me?
Yep.
Okay, so I'm going to yell to my comrade to start calling rangers. So my...
Is that your volley fire then?
That's, yeah. So rather than him taking shots, it would be him with his binoculars calling a range on my sniper shot. That kind of thing. Like doing what a spotter does rather than what... Just firing what a blind boy.
Rather than what Roland just did.
Rather what Roland...
Yeah, so Roland's kind of like Frenchman fired, like...
With a sniper, right?
So, okay, let's take a half action to aim and a half action to shoot. So let's work out modifiers.
Alright, so you're getting plus 5 from your volley. Plus 10 from the aim.
Yeah.
Plus 10 from the targeter. Plus 10 from short range, and you said it was plus 10 from accurate, didn't you? Yeah. So it's all there, what Ross spoke.
No, I just forgot the target.
Aiming
plus 55.
25, 35, 45, 55, and you said minus 20 for him running at me.
Yeah, so plus 35.
Plus 35, okay. Oh, motherfucker!
Oh, God.
Wow.
Right, so you had to roll a 76 and you rolled
an
80.
An 80. Mother!
Yeah, so the orcs are now loving this because, like,
a trained marksman that can hit the side of a barn.
Yeah, so well, we also just went down in our transport ship.
Yeah, so not only the orcs are this, the survivors that can see this are a bit like, what's happening? Who are these clowns? The orcs now kind of split their approach now, so one group breaks off left. And then the other one keeps coming straight at Sarge. They're still running full pelt, so... It is now Sep's turn.
Yeah. I'm going to do what Alex just did, but I'm going to hit. Bush!
Every turn we're taking, we're discovering new things, so it's getting more and more likely to hit.
Bush! Fire! Let the Emperor gauge your shots, Bush!
And also fire at the same guy. I'm not going to cold shot, just shooting him normally now.
So
short
what
range,
is...
standard shot, aiming with accurate, but I don't have a targar.
Alright, so what weapon are you using?
My sniper rifle.
Yeah, okay. Assuming you've got your target on your mallet then.
Yeah, it's a plus 25. No!
These rolls are fixed, man.
Yeah. Ah, the mud! I slept in the mud. And then I'm gonna move. Can I move, yeah?
No, yeah, 3 meters.
3 meters? I'm gonna move to the other side of base, because I see the orcs coming. So each square is a meter, right? What the fuck? How can each square be a meter? How can it be 8 meters to move to the other side of someone?
I'd say the rangers I need to sort out because they're a bit skew-iffy.
Okay. Well, I'm basically moving to that. Is that okay to do that?
That's fine, yeah. What is Bess's supporting fire? So we know what Yuri's...
Oh, Bess is dual las pistols.
Oh, so she's just doing like the...
She's the pilot's accountant.
She's doing the anime...
Yeah, exactly.
But she doesn't have any feats for two fighting.
She's actually wearing those grandma glasses and has like grey hair and a bun with a pencil in it and like those chains from the glasses and wearing a long skirt.
I'm just like, it's like in the film Hot Fuzz when the granny gets the
yes.
Oh yeah.
Right, okay, so that's another whiff shot, isn't it?
Yeah.
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 There's a lot of them today.
A lot of whiffs.
Alright. Well,
Johan,
yeah,
fight with
honor. I'm just reading up on craftsmanship, what it does again.
Craftsmanship is not attainable here.
not
just sits down and starts crafting something.
So it's
I'm reading the journal.
Okay, yeah, actually she's got a shotgun because that's pretty cool. Like this scene.
Okay, again, I aim as a half action and try to shoot the guy. Maybe
you can do it.
Maybe
is
I won't.
Is he within 30 meters?
And again, I'm using the burst.
Oh, he's just outside your short range.
Short range would be what? That's 10?
30. 10.
But he's yeah. just outside short range.
Shame.
Nice.
What was that? A auto burst?
Yeah.
So nice. That's another two hits, so you've hit three times there. So, what were you shooting at?
Lasgun.
What were you shooting at, though?
Who were you shooting at?
Again, the guy.
The same runner header.
Yeah, okay. Like this.
Isn't all every single degree of success? Samuel is every second degree of success, right?
So what was it? Full auto burst, you said?
No,
it was
the second
semi-auto burst.
Oh, semi-auto, okay, my bad.
Yeah.
So I hit three times?
Yes, so three damage rolls.
Sick!
10-7!
Okay. It's a hot shot, last guy.
Sweet, how you see my mewa.
That's insane! Why did you bother with a sniper rifle?
It's got a pimped last gun, basically.
Yeah.
So let me just work out how much damage that is. Because orcs are, as an Imperial Guardsman, you know, they're extremely tough and hard to take down, so...
What location did it hit?
The D100's on the D100.
Yeah, it's on the D100. So what did you
do? 9.
4. Do you not reverse them?
Yeah, you're finessing.
14. Right arm!
Yeah,
no,
so you
hit. No, she rolled a 9, not a 41.
I rolled a 9, so that...
Yeah. 9.
So what was it? What was the location?
Head.
Head, I think.
Head.
Okay, let me just double check how much damage you've done.
Unless you unless you count it as 0-9 and reverse it for left foot or whatever it is.
Oh yeah, don't you reverse it?
Yeah, you reverse it, but I don't think you do it for single figures. It's single figures is always a headshot.
Right, so toughness, you take off each hit, don't you? So
yeah.
Right, so that doesn't quite kill him, but this particular orc is very, very wounded. and his goading's like stopped immediately and he's all but fallen over currently.
So his head looks like a barbecue tomato?
Yeah, pretty much. So he's got a hole in his head where Spep's shot hit, and then there's like pieces of skin that's been sheared off and melted off. But he's still going.
Does it do anything that... I mean,
why is it not updating the health?
What? When do we count critical hits?
When he's got less than... They don't take critical hits.
Oh,
no,
okay.
No, I've discovered that. It's only PCs that take critical hits.
Okay, that's cool.
That's a problem. I've cloned all the tokens. So, that's fine, I'll have to just track that.
You can unlink their HP.
How do you do that?
Go open up the token and then just toggle it off. Open up the token under basics on where HP is.
Yeah.
Just click HP and then put on blank.
I don't know where that is, mate.
So if you double click on the token.
Yeah, done that.
And then, do you have the HP recorded on the token or in the character sheet?
On the token, it's
on
wounds.
The token. And it should say wounds. So click where it says wounds and it'll be a drop down menu.
Yeah.
Scroll all the way up to the top and click nothing, blank.
Ah, right, okay.
Yeah, and now it's unlinked.
Right, okay, I get you. So yeah, that's me not knowing roll 20.
Does okay. everybody have the weapon training for solid projectiles when we're
yes.
firing with sniper?
Yeah, you are trained in weapons, otherwise you get minus 20.
Wait. Okay.
You need to be trained in solid projectiles.
You did that with us,
Because I am only trained... Where is it? So, talents and traits, it says weapon training, chain, last, and low tech. But I don't have projectile weapons.
God. You can use sniper rifles then.
Well, yeah, minus 20 in all your shots.
Wait, so guys, I thought we got our weapon training from our squad.
Nope. No, we didn't.
Did you get it because... Okay, that makes
sense.
God, can I have my targets on my pistol?
No, I have the weapons training for sniping, so sword projectiles.
Take out low tech.
Wait, everybody has those?
Yeah.
No, make him take out one.
Yeah, that's what I mean, take it out. There's no point in having low tech, because none of you use low tech.
Okay. Thank God, because I don't have solid projector either.
Yeah,
but you don't need it, you've got your hot shot.
Yeah, you just won't use your sniper rifle.
Anyway.
Right. You have to get minus 20 if you ever use it.
Michael, no, I didn't know all the different.
Unless you swap out a weapon training, that's what you said.
Yeah, well, that's what I did.
Okay.
I don't have low tech now.
Okay, guys, we're good. We're good.
Don't worry, it was just them being idiots, Scott.
Yes.
It's fine, I knew this would happen.
I
took it too, because I totally knew I need to have weapon training with a sniper rifle to be able to fire it.
I debated to go for the long last, but no, you wanted to have solid,
Right, back on track. Okay, right. Auto.
Alright, I point at the left-hand side or corridor, and I say, Roland! We're focusing this one. He says, "We commandant, or we."
Why is he French?
Because he's doing the French volley fire.
Right? Yeah.
That's what he said.
Yeah. Okay, that sticks.
So he's a Frenchman now.
Yeah.
And.
Oh, we commandant.
I aim and I take another sniper shot.
Sacre bleu!
Okay.
So they're still running, right?
Uh huh. Yeah, they've been running full belt.
So this turn he's magically trained in sniper rifles.
Well, last time I also forgot plus 10 for something, so it should be plus 45 minus 20, right? Because I'm aiming and I'm accurate and I have the targeter and it's short range. So that's 45, right?
No, so you also get for just a standard shot. Gets you a plus 10.
So that 10. Would be another plus 10.
55. Okay,
wait.
55 minus 20 for them running.
Yeah, okay. Let's do this. Fuck. Alright, that's for my full action.
Every time.
Right, so just one moment.
Are we tracking shots as well? Because I did.
Yeah, you better be taking off your armor.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that was my second shot.
I fired three.
Right, okie doke. So back around to Yurik.
Yep, I'm gonna aim up another one at this bloody guy.
The one that's nearly dead.
Yeah, the one that's nearly dead. And I'm like, just called Artho. Right, real range this time, Artho. We need to take this guy down.
You're a bit groggy from the flight still.
There it is.
Right. Yeah.
There it is.
So you do an extra 2d10 damage.
You rolled an 8.
Right, so just, roll damage.
Roll your damage because I want to see if this works for flavour, because I would like to actually do some crit damage to see what happens. So any 10s that you roll on damage are retrospective.
No, you just do an extra 2d10 damage, you don't include your bonus. So you do an extra 4. So that means it's added to the same shot, which means it does more damage over his toughness as well.
Okay.
Wow.
So 16 total.
Yeah, but his first shot is the only one that did 8, isn't it?
No, but you add plus 2d10 to that.
I've only fired one shot, so the other two don't actually count.
What was it then?
So, 16 damage.
Right, cool, that's fine. I just wanted to make sure you did actually kill him. Where did you hit him?
I rolled an 8. In the head.
Yep. Alright, so that obliterates his head that's already taken a lot of damage, and you bring that one down.
You hit where my bullet's lodged.
Yeah, describe it a little bit further.
Yeah, just straight through his eye.
Yep, so that's one orc down, and he kind of slumps to the ground. Face plant, because he's running full pelt. Okay. So the runt herds they're oblivious at the moment. They don't actually notice that he's dead, so they're still running full pelt.
Oh, damn it. That's why it was dark enough.
Yeah, as well.
Uh-oh.
Okay, they're still running full pelt, so they're still using the full movements. And it is now Sep's turn.
Okay, I'm going to move. So you move 3 meters no matter what in a turn, right?
Yeah, that's your half action.
Yeah. Oh, it takes an action to do that?
Yeah, it takes half action to move. I think.
No, what? No, half action to move, you move 6 is what you said.
Move, half full. Move up to agility bonus as a half action.
Yeah, half move, full move, or charge and run.
So what's a full move?
A full move is just your full action. That's what I don't understand. Why would you have a full move when you can run?
Maybe if you're melee combat, because it gives them a +20 to melee?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay, well then I will move, because this doesn't matter anyway, it's in range. I'll just shoot this guy. I'm going to half action bring out my melee gun!
Melee gun against the snow, I don't think it's... They're like for vehicles, Ross.
Sergeant, what do you think about
it? Yeah, so this is like a complete misuse of...
Imperial equipment. Yeah.
Breach of protocol, man.
The Emperor blesses! So
Ruska's character is the guy who throws the holy hand grenades, right?
Yes. Yeah, pretty much.
Oh, it's only a clip of 5, I didn't realize them, right? Oops. Okay, no, I don't. I'm not just gonna blast this guy. I'll just mess. Okay.
Right, just who are you aiming at?
I'll just normal shot with my sniper rifle for the end of this guy. I didn't realize only a clip of 5. So I've only 5 bullets this melee gun. Yep. Right, my target is not on the melee gun. That's never.
No, but then you just have to spend the time an action to reload it.
But I don't have any other ammo.
He doesn't have any ammo. He literally has the weapon and the clip.
Oh really?
Yeah.
And we didn't get to acquisition any ammo.
No, it's basically as it is. His regimental special weapon is a melee weapon. His weapon in his class gives him the regimental special weapon.
Yeah.
But it doesn't say anything about clips, so.
Yeah, so does that mean I have only got what I've got for my sniper rifle as well, then?
No, because the sniper rifle is a standard equipment.
It doesn't say we have any ammo.
How many clips do we have?
There should be clips on there, I'm sure.
No, we don't get any clips because we requisitioned it. However, Alex got 2 sniper rifles if he took another one.
No, I think
that's quite an
update to you guys, didn't it? I said, do you not
want to
take clips? Right, yeah, I remember that.
So,
I just like to think that Alex has like those one action muskets or crossbows, and his comrade just hands him the loaded one every time they get
touched. And that's what the specialist's feat is. The specialist, one of the specialist's comrade characters, that they carry all the weapons.
Yeah.
And just hand you them as you need them. So you don't...
Like a doctor.
Because it takes an action to switch weapons, so if you switch, that's a half action.
One hit, yes.
Yep, one hit on this guy. So my target is not on my melee gun then. It's on
That's fine.
Because I've only got 5 shots with the melee gun.
Every round of firing so far, you've switched it between the weapons that you're using.
No, because I haven't used the melee gun yet. I've never used it. I just deliberately I took a -10 last turn for no reason and missed.
Fair enough.
So this turn actually hit. Just a normal hit. No extra. No 2D success of damage.
Scott, can you click this off?
It's not a 10.
Which one?
Oh god, I'm on this one.
Yes.
And like cross it out.
Yes, how do you do that?
On the bottom right, click the token once, don't double open it, and on the bottom right there's a little swirl. Click the swirl.
Swirl.
Click the X. Click the X, the X is better.
There you go.
Right,
yay! So no one's rolled any Righteous Glory yet?
Nope.
Right, it's the same as your first shot on the orc. It hits soundly, but it's not done an awful lot of damage.
It's not on his head either, this one is 50, 85.
They've got a lot of armor.
Right leg.
Right leg.
Left leg. Right leg. Right leg.
Yeah?
Yep, right leg.
Okay. So,
three,
you basically blast out a chunk of his leg, but he's still solidly come marauding towards you, whooping and hollering.
Whoop whoop! Party okay. In the house! Whoop whoop!
Bowl, your turn. So your immediate threats are those two Gretchens.
I mean, I guess one of them is also...
Tell them their guy's dead.
Yeah, you're a stormtrooper with carapace armor. You're the front line, Johan.
Yeah.
They only have shivs, Johan. They can't harm you.
I mean, I'm just saying that they are heading towards us, while the other three are heading towards our commander and...
Remember, the Emperor blesses. These guys don't get righteous fury.
Yeah, I'll do a... Sorry, I had damage accidentally. So, I get plus 10 for my targeter. I get another plus 10 for aiming. I get... what else?
Plus 10 from accurate. Is accurate? I don't know. Is your weapon accurate? No, accurate. Plus 10 from shooting as a standard. No, you're doing semi-auto, right?
Right, yeah. So what type of action are you taking? What shot are you taking?
Single shot.
So you're taking one standard action.
Single shot, you get plus 10.
Shot range, plus 10.
Plus 10.
Target, plus 10.
So plus 30.
Aim.
Minus 20.
Is he aiming? Are you aiming as a half action?
Yeah, I'm aiming as a half action.
Plus 40. And?
And they're running, minus 20.
So 20.
Minus 10, yeah.
So 20, plus 20.
2 degrees. Nice. But it's not accurate.
One shot, so...
Oh no, it's only in accurate stuff you get the benefits of that thing, right?
Yeah, so which one are you shooting? That one I've just pinged.
Yeah, the one that you just pinged.
Okay, roll me some damage then. Right, where did you hit?
You rolled 41, 14.
41, so I switch it to 14.
Yeah.
But don't matter, you obliterate that Gretchen.
Nice.
Yeah, that Gretchen just basically evaporates.
It would have been right arm, right?
So isn't it on the roll to hit that it sends the location?
Yeah. It's whatever you roll determines where it is. And yeah, I think we reversed it in Alice's campaign.
Yeah, I just like to imagine it like the operator in the Matrix blasting the traitor with the lightning gun.
So you rolled a 41. Is it? Yeah, 41. Yeah, so 14.
And
14
right arm.
Right, okay. So yeah, you basically obliterated that and evaporated it with your hot shot last gun.
And I forgot how far they moved per turn.
18.
They've been moving 18 meters, so they're very fast.
Just like us.
Okay, yeah.
For something so small, they're really fast.
I'm like, Yuri, can you take care of the big
faster,
one?
Right? You have high agility, don't you?
Me?
Yeah?
Not that high.
Do you have 3 or 4?
3.
Ah, okay, no. You're the same.
Right, so you've used full action in E, you can say anything.
Yeah, I'm like, Yuri, can you take care of the big one? And I point at the big one.
Okay. All right, Kev, your turn.
All right.
Kev, your turn. Yeah, that's fine.
Does giving a command, like how does it work? Command is something I don't use in combat to give somebody extra actions or extra like bonuses or something, right?
Let me just check. Command is a skill.
Because if I could, I would, for example, command Yuri to take another shot or something.
Alright, so command, special uses for command. Inspire. As full action, the character can make a charging command test to inspire one of his followers. Inspired followers receive plus 10 on the next skill or characteristics test. So you get plus 10 on the next shot. Terrify. You could use a command skill to try and cause fear in something that doesn't already cause fear.
Okay. Yep. Okay, I'm back. Sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, so you could use your command to give plus 10 to someone that you nominate, or you could try and terrify one of the creatures.
Could just one of them, or...?
Yeah, one of
Okay. Well. So let me see how far away they are.
Oh, in fact, no. Ignore me. So the actual way the terrify is used is to try and terrify the friendly creature into not being afraid of what it's afraid of, and okay. to be afraid of you instead.
Makes sense. give me a second. I just need to tell my roommates that I'm not attending.
Okay.
Yeah, go take on your turn. I guess Yuri keep going. Or is it Yuri's turn next?
Yeah, it is.
Alright, so let's see. How far are they away? 40 meters, so that means they will reach me running up to me next turn. But, like, the charge range is only 9 meters, so they cannot move and attack me next turn, right? They can only close in on me.
Let me just double check.
Yeah, you can run and attack.
Yeah, they can't. Certain creatures can.
Oh, I can't?
Not unless you've got, I think it's a certain charge.
Or charge or something.
Yeah.
Okay. Can I take, like, can I hold my action to attack one with my chainsword if they come in range? Or does that not work? In...
Right, see all the combat actions, by the way, they're all on page 243 of the PDF.
Yeah.
There's a list of all the 43? Actions you can take. Yeah,
243.
Right, so you can overwatch, which you shoot, which you think you want to do, shoot a target when it comes into range?
Well, I don't want to shoot, I want to melee. Hmm.
That's still be Overwatch?
No, Overwatch is ranged. I say, yeah, it says ranged.
Oh, so is parrying also.
Parry is usually a reaction.
Okay. So. I guess it would be ready?
Ready.
Ready a weapon or an item. Well, you can go and read that. You can just scroll down and it tells you what it does.
Ready, draws a weapon or retrieves an object, stored in a pouch, a weapon or item can also be, but this action can also be used to do things such as apply, no. So that's not what it's for.
Ready's about drawing a weapon out.
Yeah.
Ready for action.
Sorry about that, I didn't see that.
You can delay.
Yeah, I guess. I will delay till they reach me.
You could also aim or something, I think.
So I get my chainsword ready, and I brace for impact, basically.
Yeah, so you can take a half action before your next turn.
You can so you should aim before you delay.
Well, but I'm gonna melee, so...
You can aim on a melee, yeah.
Okay. But it takes half action to take out
take your weapon, yeah.
So I'm getting out my chainsaw and I say, Roland, brace yourself. And then I go like, vroom, vroom, and I start aiming, I guess.
No, you can't aim if you brought out your weapon. Can't do that.
What?
If you brought out your weapon, you can't aim.
Okay.
Throwing weapon to half, and then using your half action to delay.
Yeah, that's what I do.
And Roland is like, oh, oui, my lord.
Oui, sergeant.
Oh, yeah, hon. Baguette.
They will regret the day they faced us in battle.
Alright, okay, so,
I like how Roland turned from your standard English kid into a Frenchman.
Right, so what I need to do, all of you, just make a quick awareness test for me, plus 20.
Man, I got 47 perception for a reason.
Remember, plus 20 is not a plus.
It's just 20, yeah.
What?! 94! No, Bess, it's okay.
Wow!
98.
Oh, I'm successful.
Right, okay, so Sepp and Sarge are a little bit preoccupied.
Val, what is your fucking...
However, Val and Yuri both notice if you take your map down a little bit to the first building, there's now a mob of orcs that have kind of been drawn to the fight. These guys, so there's been orcs and platoon members fighting all around you, so there's just been fights pretty much everywhere. However, these guys are obviously taking interest in your little skirmish.
god.
So there's three orcs and one orc that's got a
Shaggy.
Slightly bigger gun than the rest of them.
I'm gonna mate with that fucking guy, Sergeant.
Permission.
You go inspire me and I got like full aim because if I miss
but
the shot.
But you still don't have a clip.
Ross, you're like the penguin guy from Madagascar. The one that just says kaboom.
Yeah. Right, Yuri.
The little Gretchen can't close the gap, can he? Mm. Next time.
Can someone keep an eye on the round number as well for me, please?
The one? The what?
You can add, you can add it to the tracker.
Fourth round.
We can just keep it. You can close in now.
Cool, that's fine. I'm gonna aim and shoot the big one. This guy. Scott's not looking.
Yep, sorry, I was checking something. Yep, that's fine. Yep.
Yeah, okay. Do that.
And plus 35 because I'm aiming and all that shenanigans. Nice.
So an extra D10 on the damage.
Yeah. So 11 plus.
You don't get Righteous Fury on the extra D10s, I'm afraid.
What is Righteous Fury?
Righteous Fury gives you a crit.
So 13 damage with pen 3.
Alright, okay, what location did it hit?
74. And the 47 in the chest.
No, you reverse it.
You reverse it.
Yeah, 47, so it's reversed on the chest.
Alright, okay.
No, reverse as the left, right leg.
Yeah, no, you rolled 47.
Oh, I rolled a 47, I thought I rolled a 74. Yeah, of course I rolled a 47.
Yeah, you missed it.
No, you wouldn't miss.
So does that slow him down if I hit him in the leg?
If you crit him.
No.
Scott, can I retcon something and just go into a defensive stance?
So what? You're not delaying your action?
You haven't even brought out your weapon, your sword.
Yeah, I did. I spent
no,
half,
you used half action. But defensive stance is full action, so.
Oh yeah, I guess. Damn it. Good.
So
I was even more.
Never mind me.
Alright, okay, so how much damage is it? It was 13 with pen 3. You hit him on the legs, so you don't have any armor there anyway. Okay.
13 damage, minus his toughness.
They're orcs, they'll be like toughness 6 or 7.
Oops, I broke base up.
Oh. Right, so you hit him again in the leg now. So before, when he was able to stand perfectly fine on the leg that had been shot out, he's now kind of limping and stumbling.
Yeah, we both had the same spot.
Yeah.
Good work.
Nice. Yeah, you guys like to hit the same locations, don't you?
Two headshots, two leg shots. You need to just copy me, man.
Right, okay. So,
you hit him in like the meat of the thigh. I've just blown out his knee. That's the difference from our marksmanship abilities.
Okay, buddy. Okay.
So, yeah, the Gretchen that was being led by the runt herd that got shot in the head and killed now notices that its master has been killed, kind of takes a little bit of a backlogging glance and quite a little bit startled, but then continues moving anyway. But because he kind of stumbled and looked back, he's not moving as far. So.
Master!
By the way, the eyes in this other arc that's coming, by the way.
He only took a half action.
Greens ready.
Okay, Sep, your turn.
I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm just gonna shoot the guy.
The orc.
The orc. Also, have you looked at the orc who's coming towards us? It's pretty funny that he's got red eyes.
Yeah, he's got goggles on.
72. I can't believe we have the same ballistics here, by the way.
Yeah.
We all
isn't that amazing? We just have like the same ballistic.
Yeah, that's Philip, let's just have ballistic.
So yeah,
can't everybody be a markman and master marksman?
Alright, so that's the leg. That's the leg again, by the way.
Okay.
Oh no, wait, is it? No, it's not traverse, isn't it? Hit damage. Damage for a sniper.
So 27 is...
27 is the body. Damn it.
Right, okay, so you've got pen 3 anyway, so that's fine.
I don't think I don't think it solves 12 damage.
Yeah, no, that's just enough to take him down, so you hit him in his chest and kind of blow his back out, and he does the same thing, face plants.
Well done, Bless! Emperor protects!
Oh, aye, it does, dear!
Oh, yes, the Emperor, quite!
Yes, yes!
And then she's probably like, oh,
I'm glad that scary orc is dead!
Because she's a coward. Lol!
Okay,
Just give me your ammo.
Let me take him off then.
Yeah.
Right, there we go. What I imagine this is like Starship Troopers. and he's always, what's his name? The main character is always protecting the his girlfriend, isn't he?
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly it.
That's it, I'm the main character from Starship Troopers.
Or you're one of the ones that dies horribly.
We'll have to wait and see.
Right, Val, your turn. Oh, by the way, the guys that noticed that extra pack of orcs coming, did you echo that out?
Incoming! It wasn't my turn, probably. But yeah, we...
No, I was, to be fair, I was looking down my scope at the other guy.
Alex, was that the original screen from the Dawn of War intro cinematic?
What? The what?
The incoming. And it's like, INCOMING!
Yeah.
And then just the mech and the orcs clash.
Yeah.
No,
I like that first cinematic on the first Dawn of War game is awesome.
Exactly. That's why I try to hit the... What's the name? Bessie?
Great.
No.
Fuck off. Not Bessie.
Like the name?
The Gretchen is.
Yeah, like the name.
Okay, just, not like the name.
Just like the name.
They're basically goblins.
I try to hit the one in front of Alex. Again, single
not
shot.
In front of Fury.
Yeah, Alex isn't in here.
Yeah,
oh, so you went quiet again, Johan.
Right, what kind of shot was that?
It was single shot.
Okay.
So 2d10 on your damage, right? No.
No.
It's not accurate.
Yep, so you obliterate that one as well.
And I shout to Alex, try to focus down the big ones. I'll take those little ones out.
Yep. Way ahead of you.
Okay.
As I'm lighting up my next shot.
So no one has made Sergeant aware of this new group. Make its way to watching. Okay, that's fine. Kev, your turn.
Can I roll awareness to see if I...
No, because that awareness is for you during the battle to notice it as a whole.
Again, I would assume that the sergeant already knows this and he would be annoyed if I tell him about it.
Yeah, totally, because I'm always annoyed when people give me information that might be needed for survival.
No, I mean, because I guess Val...
Okay, you don't have to justify your action.
I just like to think that Val is like standing in a corner and is like, I don't want to tell the sergeant, what do we mean?
No,
okay,
I
just take a defensive stance.
Johan, you gotta turn yourself up, by the way.
And so you went from last turn, and now take a defensive stance.
So you didn't even use your half action.
Yeah, what was I supposed to do with that? Because aim...
Attack?
Attack with what? They're not
charge.
In range.
Mm. Yeah, well I thought they'd come in range.
Apparently not.
And that's what you thought too, that's why you brought your sword, right?
Yeah.
And defensive stance is only good if they come in range too.
Yeah, but they only have melee weapons, right?
No, they've got little pistols, but they're not using them. Yeah, they're kind of like bloodthirstily charging towards you.
Yeah, I'm just awaiting their charge.
I
guess
sure.
I'm going to use my half move to move 3 meters.
Can't move your half move.
Oh,
yes, because I delayed, so I have 3
meters. Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, you can. Mm-hmm.
So I just gained 3 meters on them, guys.
Okay. Why are you using defensive stance, by the way? Can you hurt people with parry?
No.
No, so you can just stop taking damage.
But I cannot melee them this round, Ross.
Yeah,
but
if they're able to melee you, right, yeah. Which is what you think with defensive stance, right?
Mm-hmm. They are able to melee them.
Then you can just wait and hit them when they get in range.
Yeah, but if I don't take my defensive stance, when I take my defensive stance, next turn when they reach me, they will have minus 20 to hit.
Yeah, alternatively, next turn when they reach you, you can hit them and kill them.
Yes, no? But...
Anyway,
I can, yeah.
Stop arguing that fight, it's stupid.
I'd rather not be hit by two guys than kill one and be hit by one guy.
Yuri, your turn.
Yeah, I'm gonna line up. I'm gonna shout across first of all. Sarge, another group to the south.
Sarge's like, oh, finally, I know.
My head swings around and I'm like, got it, and I immediately regret stepping out of cover.
I then line up a shot and. Short range, 78 meters.
I don't know how Yuri and me saw those. They're behind the rock for me and Yuri is scoping.
Yeah, but my spotter isn't. My spotter would have not.
Yeah, I don't know how Val saw it.
Yeah, I'm like, I feel there's danger approaching.
So presumably it's one looks like the boss.
No, not so much. They're all kind of orcs of the same kind of stature. It's just one's got a bigger gun.
Okay, well, I'm going to shoot the one with the bigger gun. More DACA.
Yeah, that's exactly
the technical phrase. I'm gonna aim up. Also, I just so you're aware, I'm prone, which means people taking ballistic tests against me are at minus 10.
Okay.
I just realised there is a benefit of being prone, not just flavour of being prone. But people taking weapon skills against me get a plus 10.
Like, exactly like in D&D.
Yeah. So, disadvantage to hit when lying down. I'm going to sniper rifle again at the guy with the Mordaka.
Yeah, alright, so you're doing what, cold shot?
No cold shot.
Just your aim, okay.
Just a standard with an aim. Nice.
Cool. Oh,
hit this damage.
27, that's body.
Yeah.
Oh no, 27 is left arm. Right.
Yeah, left arm.
That means that guy's left arm. I killed him.
So if he's carrying a heavy weapon and I injure one of his arms, that means...
No, you have to crit it to do anything.
Oh, right, okay.
Cold shot, his weapon!
Yeah.
Can you do that?
So yeah.
How much damage?
11 damage with pen 3.
See to link this guy's wounds real quick. So it's 11 damage with pen 3 on the arm.
On the left arm.
Okay.
This guy.
That's right, so you do hit him soundly. But he's still standing.
He's still standing.
So cover gives you extra armor.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, can you be prone and in cover?
Yeah, but it's kind of flavor wise. So, the prone would give you extra evasion to the shot, and then the cover would give you extra armor if the shot hit you.
Okay, yeah. I get it.
So, you could, in theory, be prone and cover, but how would you fire?
Yeah, I mean, as long as you can say to me, like, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to. Yeah, I get it. Okay.
If you can tell me how you're doing it, that's fine. So for you, I'd say, like, if you want to go prone, you'd be, like, lying on the embankment with just
Yeah, exactly. Just the sniper in my head, yeah, exactly. Bess holding me up.
Okay, so...
Using Bess for cover.
Sorry, I didn't even actually roll these guys into the initiative, so let me just do that now. So I'm rusty as hell with this.
Philip, are you going to keep you going to defensive stance the rest of the game? Yeah.
Whoops.
Yeah. Stop mocking me, Ross. Come on.
He's your sergeant. He will kill you.
Yeah.
Well, no, it's a feasible course of action. Right.
Well, I mean, I can't really kill
I know, it's a Gretchen's turn. Right? You missed the Gretchen's.
There is actually two alive. That's my mistake. Right, so these guys finally notice that you've killed both the grunt herders and they're just frozen in terror at the moment, kind of skittering, they don't know what to do. Kind of just sitting around on the spot.
Come at me, finally!
I just want to charge at them, but they're 1 meter too far.
Yeah, so as I say, they stop dead and they don't do anything apart from kind of panic. And it's Val's turn.
Hey, Val, you're going to hit him in this thing.
Ah, cool.
Well, it's technically you both fucked him at the same time, so.
I'll aim and shoot at the
next Gretchen.
So you're shooting at the ones that are panicking and they're not doing anything. You're
shooting fresh in a barrel.
Val, shoot the big ones.
I have that out of range.
Oh, okay.
Also, I would have
to... Plus, you can't see him. There's a giant fucking boulder anyway.
Yeah, I just know where, exactly where they are. It's just my instinct.
Sick.
Sure, you killed another one there.
Yeah. Roll damage just to see, because you might not if you rolled really.
Oh, wow. I jinxed it.
No, you didn't actually kill him.
Shit!
Oh, my God.
Which one did you shoot?
The one closest closer to me.
Yeah.
Okay.
He did hit him very hard, but he's kind of panicking and flailing about, so that's probably why you missed him. You were leading the shot, expecting him to run, but then he stopped and started panicking.
And he only shot off his nose.
Okay, so, Seth, your turn.
Well, I would shoot the bad guys, but you know, the sergeants made the genius decision of standing in the.
I mean, you can still take the shot, but.
Marker fire there. No, he didn't tell me to shoot the bad guy, so I'm just gonna fire off one of the wee Gretchens who now stand still. So that's a plus. I mean,
they are standing still, so I should have gotten a lot more.
Yeah, so that's a
Which
hit.
Doesn't matter, but.
Plus,
so
now,
it's
can
just...
I add a modifier to D10? Let's just see if this works. Oh, no, you can't. Okay. Hit, and then I roll 2d10.
So, just at the closest orc to you.
No, this, I can't shoot the orcs. This is...
Oh, is that the Gretchen?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I did 20 damage.
What, the one that Val shot?
No.
The live one. Okay, yeah, so he just gets, like, gibbed.
Sergeant! They're brigades, but my bullets can't guide through them, through yourself.
So I get the image that the Gretchen, when the orc died, it's like, ah! They got shot. And his friend got gibbed, and he's just lost his voice now. He's literally frozen. Like. I think he's kind of reduced to the play dead. I might ignore you.
So I'm like, Sarge, should I shoot those guys in front of you and in front of me?
I use my half action to switch to my pistol and I shoot the one that got killed.
You can have your pistol and your chainsword out at the same time.
I thought I was... Okay, well, then I did that. And I aim and shoot at the still-standing Gretchen.
You get a plus 30.
You aim!
Plus 35.
Aim is half an action, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you're going to aim and shoot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Although, do you not? I think you might take a penalty for dual wielding. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think you do.
Yeah, so what is it? Am I holding both of them or am I changing weapons, guys? You can't just tell me, oh, you're doing this. And I say, why would you do that? Come on. That's just.
No,
it's very confusing.
It's up to Scott.
Right, okay.
Because I'm pretty sure I asked during character creation and you said I need several feats for that, or talents.
No,
and I'm pretty
can't.
Sure I read about that as well.
I'm just trying to find it now.
Did you roll for handed this?
Yeah, I'm right handed.
Oh, okay.
No, you don't get to roll for ambiguous.
You can't roll for being ambidextrous.
Right, yeah, so if you're holding your gun in your secondary hand, you get a minus 20, or your weapon in the man, you'll get a minus 20. So you can do it, you can draw and fire, but if you've not got your gun in your main hand, you'll suffer a minus 20.
So, basically, since he's not moving, it's like the same as if he would be running at me. And Ronald is still doing suppression fire, so that would be what? Standard shot, not aiming because I just draw it, right?
Yeah. So 10 plus 5 for the volley fire.
It's not got a Targar, it's not...
Plus another 10 for standard shock, right?
Yeah.
So it would be plus 5 only.
Yep.
I just need to check some real quick, so I think I forgot something for these guys.
Well, the Gretchen's dead anyway, so...
Yeah, I'm gonna say he's dead, obviously something for future reference.
Okay, you're saying he's dead? Well, that's a difference, because I'm just 1 meter close to chainsawing him.
Right, so
well, I think he should roll to hit anyway, because he hasn't rolled.
Oh, right, I thought he did.
No, I didn't.
Oh, yeah, I mean... He's
got terrible BS.
Thank you. So, I get him plus 5, right?
Yeah.
Well, that's gonna be shit. What? Yeah. What's
he's already
damage?
Took 5 damage, so it'll be hard to not kill him. 9.
10-0 though.
It's fine, he's dead. He's definitely dead.
Yeah, if I did like 12 damage, you're paying 3.
Can I see those 4 orcs? Are they, what kind of weapons do they have?
Alright, so you would know them from your training with the Tactical Imperialis. The kind of guys are holding the 2-handed weapons, the sluggers, and then the big ones, and the big slugger.
Range weapons, right?
Yeah, so they're kind of assault rifles.
Alright. Well, that's my turn. Still standing out in the open, guys.
In front of someone else's sniper rifle.
Yeah, well, you can just do a tactical roll, right?
I can just do what?
Also, you can shoot between my legs or some shit.
Okay. If that's a command, Sergeant.
I didn't give you any commands, yet you talk all the time.
I would just lag off.
I command you to shut up. Can I do that?
Yeah.
I cannot roll out of it.
There will be definitely a disciplinary action for this.
Well, not when you don't have a leg.
I mean, it's still possible, right?
Mutiny. There's actually rules for lost leg because I was trying to find dual-handed.
Oh, right. Yeah, I've just remembered as well, actually. So, Gretchen's, you actually have a minus 10 to hit because they're weaving. Orcs, you're getting a plus 10 to hit because they're hulking.
Ooh, that's good to know.
What do we get for orcs?
Plus 10.
Yes, and there's another plus 10 that we forgot to include.
Plus 65.
Well, I would have still hit the Gretchen, but I don't think I would have hit any of the orcs.
Right, so the orc slugger boy pack are going to... So he's going to hunker up and take cover against the wall.
Wait, how long the range is there, sorry, fool?
Yeah, actually, let me check.
You maybe shoot a long range there. Because, Soul Rifle's like what Johan's got, right? That's only 60.
He's still going to do it anyway. He's from Crane up there. The others, however, are going to move. So he's running. He's running. And he's staying there. Right, so the big shooter levels his gun. Regardless of the fact that the guys are in between him, he shoots at Kev.
Yay!
So eight meters. I'm gonna have to. Is there a way to GM roll stuff from the?
I think you can maybe. Is there a cogwheel anywhere?
That's on the sheet. The sheet would have to have that set in there.
No, I don't think that's the way you're doing it. I'll just roll it so you guys can see. It's fine. Alright, so he's getting. It's within his normal range, so no issues there.
So he gets plus 10, plus single shot.
Oh, it's not
just. Johan, you're so quiet.
Yeah, you just come really quiet. He's going to use.
What happened
so
to you?
This is the first attack I'm making. This particular weapon he's got does not have single shot.
Why am I so quiet?
Oh, there you go.
Right, so he's getting a minus 10 because it's a fully automatic weapon.
Shooting for his mates.
It's inaccurate, so what does inaccurate do?
Minus 10, I think. Go check. Inaccurate. Inaccurate is no bonuses gained from the use of aim action, that's all.
That's fine, so he's just gonna use two rounds of full auto burst.
Hey, no, full auto is a full action.
Full auto is a full turn.
No, full auto burst is a half action.
Is it?
What? Yes.
Burst.
Not with a sniper rifle.
I swear it was full.
Hold on,
really?
Use a full auto burst.
Yeah.
We command all.
Full auto burst is a half action, states right there.
Oh, yeah. So it is. Wow.
Alright, so what did we say? It's minus 20?
Yeah, because he doesn't get a benefit from aiming, so yep.
Hey! Alright, whiffed. And. Whiff.
Wow, minus 8. Wait, what? You didn't do that right? Wait, really? He doesn't have any positives. Wow, he had to roll under a 4.
Yeah, well, the rocks.
Wow.
They're not the greatest shooters, are they? I mean, they can't even read the word.
Okay, so.
Neither can we.
And the other orc that took cover by moving into it is going to fire at Val. Oh. So that one. Where's the sheep?
So yeah, minus 10.
Yeah, so inaccurate, you can't get any benefits from aiming.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
That's fine. He's going to take two standards then. So he's getting plus 10.
Yep.
Minus 10 from the cover that Val's in.
No, cover only doesn't give you minus 10, does it? It just gives you armor bonus.
Oh, sorry, yeah. So plus 10. He's outside of his normal range, so that's another plus 10. Minus 10 even. So that cancels, so it's just a 0.
Mm-hmm.
Anything else? No. So two hits.
Two standard shots.
So first one hits. Second one hits. First one.
I don't know.
Yeah.
On you.
It's okay, you've got extra armor. I don't think these will do any damage.
I think these are going to bounce.
How much cover are you in?
I don't know.
He described it earlier, didn't you? Not remember? Oh, so you went quiet again. Cover breach 253. So, blackboard, storage crate, sandbags, ice trees. Rock crate? What the fuck's a rock crate?
Rock crate, concrete, basically.
Oh.
So he's basically behind a...
You want to say something?
Yeah.
Quickly.
I
it's
am.
Too loud.
No,
is
no,
it?
It's not too loud, no.
So it's behind... Yeah, so you basically don't... Yeah. So bullets whiz and bounce off around you, that's it.
What
does my cover do?
Gives you armor.
How much?
12 armor points.
12 additional?
Yeah.
Apparently so.
Okay, so
it's up to the GM to determine how much cover gives you.
I have 22 armor. So
yeah, but this is a fuck off boulder.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
All the shots, even though the shots are pretty dead on, the boulder basically.
Commander, how would you classify that boulder?
Fuck off.
It only works, by the way, if it has a body part that's hidden behind cover. So isn't Johan's half out of cover because he's got his shoot?
So where did it hit then?
So Johan's left side.
And 18.
He's inside cover.
51 and 18. So 51 is body, 18 right arm.
So his right arm would not have cover.
No, his right arm would have cover.
No, his right arm's a Oh, you're right. Wait, what arm? What hand are you, pal?
What?
Either way, he's facing this way. So
yeah, I know he's
down.
Facing this way, but I'm just saying, how's he shooting me sniper rifle with his last gun with his right hand?
He can do that if you train yourself.
Yeah,
you
okay.
Can, you
so yeah, his left is left. Yeah, you're right then. Left hand.
Yeah, the right hand is on the trigger.
So if actually you won't get the benefit from the boulder. So, 12 and 11 minus your toughness and armor. Which
so
I'm pretty sure it's going to...
It's 2 and 1. I take 2 and 1 damage.
Yeah, alright.
Ow.
So you see Val get hit by a couple of slugs.
More like bits of rock.
I think it's like when it hits shrapnel and it's rock chips off and kind
so
of hits
So I start at 19 and I count down, right? For
yes. Yeah, you can
how much
19!
Yeah, he's
tank. Toughness, fucking hell.
Well, yeah, I suppose stormtroopers are the tank, they are the front line.
Could shoot him point by my sniper, I even wouldn't hurt him.
Yep.
Right, Yuri, your shot.
I'm gonna aim at the same guy as last time.
So.
Extra plus 10.
That guy?
Yep, plus 45.
Because he's hulking.
Yep. But minus 20 because he's running.
Oh, well, I'll fire at one of the ones that stood still and shot twice then.
Yeah, so the one that's addressed to the wall and then the big shooter, they both stood still and fired twice.
What you can do is you can put dots on them by the same way you put X's on them, like a blue, red, and green, and it gives us a
crazy
calling out when we're shooting.
Green dots are the ones that have stood still.
Okay, so I'm going to shoot this guy.
I just meant give each one a different dot, but yeah, that works too.
Oh, with a plus 45.
Oh, no, why is it plus 45? You stand still as plus 55,
right.
Isn't it?
So you're getting 10 for normal shot.
Oh, yeah, sorry, 55 is still plus 10.
And you also forgot the plus 10 for them being orcs, right?
No.
Yeah. Right, so let's count it again. So 10 for normal shot.
Yep.
10 for aim.
Yep.
10 for targeter.
Yep.
Plus 20 for accurate. Sorry, plus another 10 for accurate, so that's 40.
Yeah.
Plus five. 10 for hawking, 50. Plus 5 for volley.
What is this standard plus shot? Did you already include
plus
that?
55, so that would have hurt.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yep, so hit with just 1 degree, won't it?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so roll your damage.
10 with pen 3.
And it would have been a 87, which is a 78, which is a right leg. Right, so there's no armor on that, so it hits him fairly hard, but he's still standing.
Cool. Just gonna say that I can't believe I missed that.
Yeah, like I can't understand how I miss all these shots either.
Well, your turn.
I'm gonna drop down, like go prone. Oh, okay. Can I move and go prone?
You can move like 3 meters and then go prone.
Would that count as my entire turn? And short range.
I knew we forgot something.
65. Yeah, see? 65, that's what
God, I meant. Would that count as my entire turn?
Yes, that'd be the entire turn, because you're using half action to move, and then half action to go prone.
Yeah, but otherwise I can shoot at them, right?
You can.
I'd just take minus 10 too, I think.
Yeah, because you're...
Even at this guy?
What's the range of your weapon?
This guy?
What's 60? The range? 60. Yeah, they're all in range.
But he has cover, right?
He does, the two down, but they're running, so...
I shoot at one of the...
You've got pen 7, you're as well shooting into cover.
Yeah, I'm shooting at the cover guy. And
depends how much cover he's got.
It's the same cover that you're in. Oh. Val.
Fuck.
Wow. First Righteous Glory.
Get to roll all the d10.
No, but I didn't roll to
yeah,
hit.
Yeah, you can only roll to hit. Oh,
okay.
God damn it. If you miss this.
So I get plus 10 for hulking.
Yep.
Plus 10 for aiming.
Yeah.
I do a triple shot.
What are you doing?
Half auto burst, whatever.
Burst. So you lose 10 for that then?
No, it's the middle one.
Oh, right, okay. So what, the semi auto burst plus 0 ballistic skill, additional 2 hits for every 2 additional successes? That one?
Yeah.
So you don't get anything from that. So you plus 10 from your aim, plus 10 from hulking.
Then
plus 10 from
Targa. And.
Oh no, you don't have a comrade.
Yeah, no additional range. Do I get any minuses from his.
No, if you hit him, he's in cover, that's when that'll come into effect.
Haha!
What? Wow.
I rolled an 11.
So that's another 3 hits.
So I roll 3.
You're gonna blast this guy away.
So you've got four damage rolls. So
do
4 hits of damage.
But I only have 3 shots that I fired.
Oh right, yeah, so 3 then, sorry.
And does the first one count the one I already rolled or not?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh wow. My god.
Damn.
Right, okay, where did you hit him then? So you rolled a...
Don't you roll an extra d10 for each Righteous Fury?
Yeah, so roll another 2d10 for Righteous Fury. I think you killed him.
Should roll them separately, because each hit is separate.
Right, so you
I mean, we can just count that 2d10.
And try and roll another 10 now.
It doesn't
get
cumulative. Right, so 11, you hit him in right arm. So his right arm is covered by the house.
Isn't it cumulative? I thought it was cumulative.
No, it doesn't build on top of each other. Righteous Fury specifically states it doesn't act as crit damage to build.
Oh, I think we did do that. No,
right, so he does get a lot of protection. You're not going to like it because it blocks all the damage.
All of it?
Yeah. Because it's a rockcrete / stone, so, you know. It's a solid house. It's 16 armor points, so.
So you shot the guy in cover, though?
Yeah.
But with pen 7?
Yeah.
Yeah, 16 protect you got it yourself.
It's 16 armor points.
So it takes 7 off, so you have to do above 9 damage to be able to damage it.
Yeah, but I did 40. Didn't
and then
yeah,
he's got his own armor.
His own stuff. So
it's, the most thing he did was 23, so minus 16, minus 9
no.
from that. 12. So yeah, he must have done some damage, right? He doesn't have 12 toughness.
Yeah, let me make it. Right, alright, I see. Yeah, I'm working out wrong, that's why. So the first. So it's 23.
And 16 is the next highest, which is probably nothing.
Yeah.
Dependent.
So, minus 9. So 23 minus 9.
If he's 7 or more toughness.
It's 13. Minus his toughness. Right, okay. So, first one does hit pretty solidly, does a fair amount of damage.
Minus 9 off the straight away, then minus toughness, minus armor.
Yeah. The second roll that you did, the 8 damage, just balances.
Okay.
And then the second righteous blow that you got...
16. So if the guy 16. Is more than 7 armor or toughness, it doesn't do anything.
Right, no, so that one does get through as well.
See.
Right, okay, so he's still fairly, you know, tough. What we need to do now is work out the crit damage. This is the funny bit. Right, so it's energy, yeah?
Yeah.
On the right arm. Right, roll me
hit
2.
Gonna explode and hit his comrades.
So, one level of fatigue. So you basically hit him in his arm that hard, it wrenches it back. This makes no sense for getting 2 righteous glories.
Hey, by the way, see when you roll a d5, you're meant to use d10s. Because they
yeah,
even get righteous fury, yeah.
Well, let's still look.
I guess, yeah, it does make a difference. It makes it slightly more likely.
Yeah, so, however, the target does not count as having suffered a critical hit for determining if he has further crit damage. So, you put one... How many points of critical damage did you do? How does this work out? You're going to have to help me out here.
I have no idea.
When rolling damage after successful attack, if any die rolls result in 10...
Going back CGM, right?
So...
Right. What page is on?
Roll 1d5 for me, Johan. So you basically roll a d5 and then consult the appropriate crit damage table. So normally crit damage is cumulative because it's righteous glory, you can only ever get up to 5. You know what I mean? So otherwise it'd build and build and build. Anyway, so 3. Let's wait until Phillips factory this out. Do you want to take a quick break?
We can take a break. Also,
yeah.
So I'm pretty sure you can roll a d10 and then if the 10 is a 10. You get another d10. Right? Because it doesn't say you can't do that. It just says it doesn't build any, doesn't count for next critical damage. Like, it doesn't start if it suffers righteous fury multiple times, but you still get extra damage. Right? So it doesn't stack critically, right? I'm pretty sure you're good. But we'll take a break! Thanks for watching us. We're on my YouTube, so it's not live streamed yet. We'll see you guys in part 2. Thanks, Philip.